red shirt? What the hell did you ever wear red shirts?
Well, I just got this fine shirt delivered to me. It's elementalist, as you can see, apparently.
Oh, wow. It's very, very appropriate.
So, yeah. Actually, oh, I shouldn't have worn this, actually, because people are going to say it's rigged now. Do you know why? You know what build a random user has?
He
has He has normal elementalist.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
So that is only normal Ellie, though, so he's a couple of meters late.
Yeah, he's got normal Ellie, but this shirt is normal Ellie, so surely this is rigged.
Yeah, if random user wins, we confirm it's rigged.
Yeah. Yeah, I rigged it. Yeah. So, yeah. It's the grand final, though. Wow. It's the grand final. See, look, there you go. Rigged. It's already happening in chat. But look at this bracket. Now, this is a stacked bracket, okay? There we go. Look at that. Jingy Innie, Ganlos Plenix, Nyxili Rim, Axel Warrior, Rex, Acolyte Saihan, Nobody versus Red Naxala. Oh. Felon versus Random, then the Seer versus Ziggy. So, holy shit. What a bracket. And let's see if the first people are here. I'm pretty sure Innie is here because they said something in chat. So I guess we can start on that. Let's see what matchup this is going to be. Actually, no. Cancel that. We have to pick a map first. Here we go.
How was that name for the druid build?
And the first... it's going to be Fofa for the first meme.
Okay. Wow, that's quite appropriate. Everyone likes this map.
Yeah,
wait.
Yeah, it's just the normal map. Standard map, isn't it?
You know.
Very, very standard. Nothing particularly special here. Will anyone go for a Lord Rush?
I hope so.
Okay, here we go. Another game.
Well, we're just putting the build in Mr. Builds, I guess. Yeah. There's just no fighting with him. The Focus Spectral Warhorn Reaper.
Right. Yes, here we go. Axel versus Rex. This one
Axel,
will happen.
Axel, the classic.
They're both in chat, so it's going to happen.
All right.
Axel has Moa, so he probably wins.
But Moa and Chrono. That's 20 seconds.
Yeah, 20 seconds of being a Moa. Rex is going to... He's going to have a good time there. and he's got shield as well, so even better.
Yeah. There's going to be some major cancer coming out here.
Yeah. He's got Chrono Inspiration Illusions, which is a really nice really nice thing to have. If he had the Scepter... Actually, no, the Scepter trait isn't that good. Never mind, cancel that. Kind of, I guess. It's
yeah, having a Scepter in the first place is a little bit... But it was quite good in the Mesmer one, if I remember correctly.
Yeah. Then we get, let's see, Time Catches Up, Illusionary Reversion, and Lost Time. So actually those traits are not the best. Illusionary Reversion's pretty good, but really what you want is the complete, you want Chrono Phantasma. That is, that's a good trait. Yeah, that's pretty
good. Yeah, Chrono Phantasma is sick.
And Time Catches Up, that's not actually that handy either in this particular situation.
Mm.
However, having Persisting Images is pretty good. Restorative Illusions is really nice, and Mental Defense is really good as well.
Yeah.
In Illusions, Compounding Power, he's going to get free Condi damage and power damage, which is nice. Shattered Strength, he's going to be stacking up Might a lot, actually. Which is going to be good. And Ineptitude. In 1v1, this is actually pretty good. In fact, it's really good. Because it's not going to get wasted on anything. You don't want it to, you know...
Mm.
You know, anything to happen. So, there you go.
Like a Clown Fiesta. Yeah. Alright, we're finally going to see some action.
Yeah. I think we are. But Rex. Let's take a... Whoa, actually, look. Rex's build is fucking disgustingly good.
Oh, my God, we didn't even look at Rex.
Yeah, he's got the shout, Deathly Chill, Corrupt Boon, Morgue Boon Corrupt, Spectral Armor.
Fakes ending.
The shout trait, Chilling Force, Terror, Weakening Shroud, Death Perception, Vital Sense, and Soul Marks. So the only thing that is not that great there is Soul Marks. Every other trait is fucking good. And all of his utilities are pretty decent, and his weapon set's really nice. Axel, he'd better be good at this game, because this could be a problem. I need to change my interface size down to small. Let's see what Axel is running. It's going to be Mercenary and Nightmare. Very expected setup here with Doom Geomancy twice over. And then for Rex, yeah, as you would expect, he's running Mercenary Crate. And Crate's pretty good, because he might get to use two Elite Shouts, you know?
Oh, yeah. And the cooldown on the crates is very small. Look at it; it's only 30 seconds for the final tier. Think of all those bleeding stacks you could do.
And if Rex is capable of dodging the mower, that's good. But then you have to dodge the mower again, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the fun never ends. Sword offhand here as well. You know, it could be pretty useful, honestly.
If you don't dodge the mower, you just lose. It's...
Well, I mean, you can run away with. You can run away though.
But there's two mowers. That's the issue. It's 20 seconds of CC.
That is true. Oh. Oh, grasping dead happens, but then it unhappens.
Yeah, nothing really
happens. There's the confuse beam.
Oh, the forced axe, very annoying. Then Rex can't cleanse it just yet.
Mass illusions. Rex is getting ten stacks of confusion. This is quite unfortunate for Rex. He is getting wrecked right now. And there's the stun. He manages to dodge it, though. The well goes down, and the mower gets interrupted there as well by
very
Rex.
Nice, very nice. And however, now there's only one mower left, of course.
He gets CC'd. Oh, but the distortion saves him from a good amount of that. The Shroud 4 there. When will the mower come out? The block
Ooh,
on the
very nice
counter.
Arcane Thievery there.
There's a lot of damage there. The Mantra is not actually charged up either. And that's mower good. And dead.
Oh, that was a pretty cool explosive match there.
That was a good game. Well.
Oh, there we go. What's he going to say?
What's he going to say? That was actually kind of close.
Yeah, well, there we go. Very, Oh.
Oh.
That's
unlike
well
Axel.
Mad.
That is very unlike
he's still
going
to be end though, I said now.
Yeah. See if Rex can make a comeback or if Axel will win with his meme build. What the fuck is that sound?
I don't know, I can hear it as well.
Yeah, what the hell is that? That's very disturbing. What's going on?
Yeah.
Beep boop. Beep boop. Anyway, Axel, he's gonna go again. This is a pretty nice chrono here for him, Axel, actually. Although, you know, if only there was... Is there a purpley sword? You know, like the great
sword?
Yeah,
there's a spooky purpley sword, yeah.
Yeah, is it a great sword there, or is it just a normal sword?
There's both.
Okay. Well, I mean, it probably looks shit, honestly. But, I mean, I think Mesmer's are good with rapiers, like this one. Because that's how they were originally pictured in Guild Wars 1. So.
Yeah.
Modern Moth says, Rex equals failfish, Axe Warrior equals feels good man. Okay, the swordsman. Will it even attack? I think it actually might.
It's on its way.
It's on its way. Here it goes. Will it make it all the way? Oh! Look at him! He's gonna do it!
Here comes the swordsman!
Oh! Hey! Oh no, it didn't do anything. It missed miserably. Oh. Oh well.
Oh, now it's going in and not back.
Okay, yeah, there you go. It did something now. And then it blew up. It detonated.
Yeah, we lived a short, happy life.
Yeah, it did. It died doing what it loved.
Yeah.
Trying to stab people. And there. Ooh! Rex manages to. Kind of not get stunned by that really.
There's a well of calamity there, Rex. Is it gonna hit? It might fully hit actually. In fact,
not
will.
The best well to have.
No, but he managed to hit it there, and Death Shroud blocked most of the damage.
He did.
His mower, and it does hit.
Oh,
and
it does hit. That is disastrous, honestly. He gets the immobilized with the sword 3. Exactly what I expected him to do, and Rex is gonna get wrecked here.
Oh, here we go. Don't worry, Rex.
Oh. What's he gonna say now?
Rex on offline.
Our match is irrelevant anyway.
Oh.
Oh. Why so?
Oh, there we go, there's a sword.
One of the OP rigged builds will win. Axel, not thinking that he's OP and rigged. Interesting. Axel wins.
Yeah,
2-0.
So what we should be doing in Mystic Builds is checking down the builds and deciding which one is the most rigged and then calling it a day saying they won.
Okay, so 250 packets of salt. Yep, I saw Random's Twitter. He has a copious amount of salt ready to go.
Oh my god.
Let's see if we can move on to Acolyte versus Saihan. I think they're here.
Alright.
So that will work. Let's see what they've got. The Druidic Druid. These Druid names only have one word for some reason.
That's pretty good. They turned out pretty good.
Yeah, they really have. But another druid.
The druidic druid.
Yeah.
So that sounds like a name for a shitty cartoon character. The druidic druid. Well, he's got a quick draw there. I like quick draw. Ancient seeds, can he use that? Not really.
Well, he can use druid, can't he? Because it works on dazed people, right?
Yeah, he can use druid, but that is just about it. We've got a lot of druids in this one.
He actually got smoke scale as well.
Oh.
Oh wait, no, he didn't. He hasn't changed it yet. No,
yeah, that's jungle. He's got jungle stalk and raven.
Yeah, jungle. Okay, I was gonna say. I mean, I was looking at him in the game, and he has smoke scale. Thinking, wow, did he actually get that? Well, let's see. What else has he got? Skirmishing and marksmanship. Strider's defense, which he can use because he's got the sword, which will destroy some projectiles. And quick draw, really nice trait there.
Yes, very, very good. Yeah. Now, has he got anything particularly used on a axe, dagger, sword, warhorn?
You want it for torture, really, don't you?
Yeah, exactly. Torch is the dream, or longbow for longbow 2.
Yeah, exactly. Which he doesn't actually possess right now.
No. So that's not so good, but you could get some extra chill or some more bleeding if you wanted to. I can't really see it being that useful in sword, seeing as sword is mostly about just like spamming shit. But you know,
I guess you could go for a double split blade with 10 stacks of bleeding. Yeah, or you could get 6 stacks of poison, or you know, a lot of bleeding with a dagger 5. I don't know. There's some things that can be used here. He's also got Protect Me, which is really nice, because it will break stun, it will also cause the pet to taunt.
That will be nice, yeah.
Which is pretty good.
So we've got a Dragon Hunter here. The traps aren't actually too cancerous. The trap, even. Anyone?
Apparently the site says he has smoke scale.
Oh no, not this again.
Let me just check. Because that would be quite unusual if that was the case. Tell us about Sighand's build while I check that shit.
Alright, well, I like this build. It looked remarkably like the Guardian build that we work with that Wrathful Spirit, Zealous Blade, and Shattered Aegis. This is sick. Mace Focus Sword Shield. That's still pretty similar to the Shattered Guardian build we use. Wow. I actually think he might have been going for that. the heal is arguably the worst. I think that heal sucks personally, but never mind. Maybe you can make do. And one trap. I believe that is the
Is that the spinny trap?
It's the spinny trap. Yeah, Procession of Blades.
Ellie giggle.
Maybe not so good in its own, but Alright, it's still Dragon Hunter cancer. No one likes that, really.
That is true. That is true. Wow, he actually got... He really did go for our build, didn't he? And he got the knockdown signet as well.
Yeah. Soaring Devastation, bit of free damage. Hunter's Determination. So he's got a second trap, essentially. Oh, more Aegis. That's actually a pretty good idea with the Shatter. Very nice. But his opponent doesn't have a massive amount of stuns, but... Something he's in Hunter's Fortification. Okay, I see what he's going with that. So now whenever he blocks, he's going to remove Condies, and his heal is a block. That is quite clever.
Yeah, he does actually have smoke scale as well.
He does.
Okay. I think I just forgot to update this one, so it panics and just goes. It just picks a random. It just picks the zeroth pet, which is Raven.
Okay.
Or is it? I don't know. He has Jungle Stalker and smoke scale.
Smoke scale. That is going to be annoying.
That's really weird, actually.
He also looks like a clown. Look at him. We have a clown.
Yeah, it's very disturbing, isn't it? Where the fuck is Sighand as well? Again,
not like this.
Sighand didn't leave, did he? No, I don't think he did. He just said something. Oh no,
yeah,
he's okay.
There you go.
No, it's fine. It's all good. Yeah. Would Protect Me taunt a clone instead of the Mesmer? Yeah, I guess it would, actually.
Wow,
I don't see any reason why not. Wow, that's a pretty rigged counter.
Yeah, that would suck against them, though.
So, Sighand is going for durability. Oh, no, resistance, not durability, because that doesn't exist anymore. So, yeah. It's reduced condition duration. And when you activate a signet, you gain Aegis. He's going for the Aegis build.
Oh, boy.
The creativity. Look at the cooldown on this shit, though. It's so bad. I really want to use this room, but it's just terrible.
Yeah,
you get a block seconds. Every 30 seconds. Are you serious? But look, the perfect synergy with Bane Signet.
Yeah, which has a 30-second cooldown. Yeah. Very convenient.
Generosity, purity, generosity, purity. He's scared of Condies. And Mender's amulet.
He's not going to have that many Condies, though, because he's got blocks. He's got the trait that removes Condies and you block.
Yeah.
He's got a little bit of everything, really.
This is a good trait.
So that means that Shelter will remove two Condies, pretty much. That's quite nice, actually. It's free, just a bit of extra Condi room, and he's going to get him so much Aegis as well.
Yeah.
This build is interesting, if nothing else.
Indeed. Oh, hang on. Is the finals thing broken? It might be. Yeah, that didn't quite... Why didn't that work?
I put my clown nose on first.
Hold on to your points. Yeah, so the pet thing is slightly broken.
Well, Acolyte is a massive clown, as you can see there. Look at him. He's definitely a clown. So
the clown fiesta.
He's a clown fiesta in essence. 50% of the players in the map are currently clowns.
50% of players are clowns. That's a good... We should post that to Reddit. Yeah, that'll be a pretty funny thingy. So, here we go. They're going to the middle. Saihan, the fuck is this? It's a gimp or something.
You put a clown on top of the one that is already permanently on your face. Oh, they should definitely add a clown nose to the store.
Yeah, they definitely should. That'll be new meta for clothing.
That'll be so good. You could fuck the human female scarf meta. It'll be the human male clown nose meta. Everyone's a clown.
Here we go. Saihan is trying to chase the Acolyte down. Will it work?
Well, so far, Saihan goes in. There's blocks for days here.
He uses the Protector Strike there. Does do a lot of damage. And then Sword 3s. Doesn't really do anything. He uses the Shield. I mean, the Shield is kind of crappy if you're the only person here, because Shield of Judgment. Only what affects you. You know?
Yeah, not quite as good as it could be.
He is getting some good damage on Acolyte. Acolyte is struggling to kill him, and he is a guardian, so he's got a lot of things he can just press and enjoy his life. And that Sword 3 does some good damage. Uses the F1 to pull in the Acolyte. Now he's going to go to Focus. He's got some more blocks here with the Shield of Wrath, and also Blinds with the Ray of Judgment, I believe. Not at all like his Guild Wars 1 counterpart,
no.
But you know what? Is also... No, you know, that's not going to work. That was a stupid segue. But Saihan might be able to secure the kill here. Acolyte seems unable to really do any damage to Saihan. But Saihan, why is Saihan not going in for the kill? I don't get this shit.
This could be the kill for Saihan.
He doesn't want to go into the smoke field. I mean, I guess.
Just fight through it, you know?
Yeah, and there's a Sword 3. A few things do get blocked because of Strider's defense. But I don't think it really matters at this point, unless it does. Nope, it doesn't. Oh, but wait. Oh, wait, why did he use fucking Bane Signet? To get a block. That's actually pretty smart. In fact, holy shit! That was actually a sick play! Because think about this. He blocked the revive interrupt, didn't he?
That's pretty clever.
Yeah. That was actually pretty smart. So the thing couldn't blind him. Feels good. Yeah. What kind of the fucking fixer upper just bops his opponent? Yeah. He couldn't use the astral thing. Did he not get enough healing or something? He didn't manage to charge it up in time, I guess. RIP.
RIP. Well, he's gonna
have to try and do this again. Sense. Maybe he needs to go with Dwayna to get some regen.
Dwayne the Rock Johnson, you mean?
Yeah. Saiyan's ready to go.
So I must have swapped his traits around. I call bullshit. No, they're all in place.
They are all in place, as you can see here.
Oh, Wrathful Spear, I love that. It's so good.
Yep. This is a glorious trait. Okay, Sam the Warden versus Saihan. This is the original Saihan, because it actually is called Saihan.
Yeah.
Hold on to your points. Seize theirs.
Hmm. Here we go. I know the chat's broken. There must be something wrong with the fucking API right now. Ziggy's throwing. In reality, they were mashing buttons randomly off cooldown.
Maybe, but it looked cool. So.
Well, I don't know. If you don't consider the fact that he had Rune of Resistance, yes, that play is beyond retarded. But actually, if you consider that he does have it, it's actually really smart.
There we go. We're just gonna sit in the reality where it was really smart.
Exactly. Okay. Here we go. The axe is being thrown. Will it do anything though? Wow, fucking Axel and Nyxley just laying into Acolyte here.
Yeah.
So harsh. But looks like Acolyte is getting a slightly better trade to start things off here. But how long will that last? The Spear of Justice.
Yeah, and it pulls him into the trap.
Oh,
very
the
nice.
Polarino. Like, well, I mean, he doesn't actually have that much power and ferocity and stuff, so he doesn't actually do that
it
much
didn't
damage.
Do that much damage, but still.
And he's dealing with a scrapper, a rune of the scrapper, and
very annoying.
Knight's thingy. So he has a lot of mitigation.
Well, that is cancerous. Wow.
Yeah. This Shield of Courage is Ebola. It's terrible. But so is the Acolyte's rune setup. As you just said. Oh, there goes the leap. And another pull in there. That was really nice there. Does get the interrupt as well. But there, a seed has gone down. However, will Saihan be able to finish? Oh, big protector strike. 1.5k damage. Oh, a mace
nice
crit.
Heal. Nice heal, though. Oh, the lift just getting
he might
off.
Be able to survive, but oh, immediately goes for the pull there. That's quite interesting. I think he maybe got a little bit greedy. He probably should have waited for the trap, because then he could have kind of got certain kill. But at this point, I don't think it really matters. And the Acolyte is going to go down.
Yeah, well, he may not have won, but he's definitely the most successful clown in the tournament. Yeah. Oh, and Saihan roleplays as the resident memester.
Missing string in Langfile. Just like that. You can't use the druid form. It wasn't. It was. Wasn't. The argument. Foreign languages, Dan's game. Let me see if I can fix Twitch chat. I don't think I can, though. I don't think there's anything wrong with it.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's not working. Why isn't it working? It was working yesterday. Let's see if we can. No, I don't think I can do it. Probably not right now. I'll just get rid of it and see if it repairs itself. It's been having some problems recently, which is a little bit unfortunate, but such is life. No, yeah, Red Naxxler is the only person to get a free win here, because unfortunately Chungi is unable to make it, and no one could replace. What a disaster.
You can't really replace in the finals.
Yeah. There were too many people. I asked about six people and they all couldn't make it. It's just wow. I mean, seriously? But whatever. Such is life, but now we come to the first game that contains random user.
Here we go.
It's Felon versus random user. So we've got Reaper. Oh wow, this is quite unfavorable for random here, actually. Mm-hmm. But this is very unfavorable for random. This is terrible for random user.
Oh wow, that is a pretty nice Reaper build as well.
Yeah.
With in terms of the skills at the very least.
Yeah.
This is that heal. Do you like that heal in PvP? What would you say?
The vampirism.
Yeah.
I think untraited it's not really that good.
Exactly.
I mean, untraited you want to go with consume conditions. Although against random it doesn't really do anything, does it?
No, not really.
I don't know. I mean, it's a solid heal. It's one of the two heals that are commonly used. It gets used, but you know, you use the Signet Heal if you take the trait because you get reduced cooldown, might, and Boon Corruption. But he doesn't have it, so there you go. Yeah. He does have Plague. Yeah.
Yeah, he's got Plague.
So. He does have Plague. Which is, I don't know, I mean, you know, it could be pretty good against random, seeing as he's got kind of a spiky, nukey build, so he can blind him and cancel it out a bit, and get extra health to absorb it, health and toughness.
I haven't really seen play being that useful, though, apart from that one time, where it just, like, won the game instantly.
Oh, no, Felon is not online. This is actually disastrous. What is going on here?
Clown Fiesta, that's what.
This is a Clown Fiesta. This is the thing, actually. We can't go on... Wait. We need to reevaluate this shit.
Are any of the first guys back?
Yeah. Maybe. Let's see if Plenix is here yet. This finals is a Clown Fiesta. Okay, Plenix is here.
Okay.
So we're going to do Ganloss versus... Plenix. Ganloss the Daredevil! Oh, man! Oh, no! I think this is quite unfortunate for him. I think he's got some confused weapon sets here.
The heal's not so great.
No, the heal's really good.
Oh no, it wasn't that Lee. I was thinking of a different Lee heal.
So, Acrobatics, Daredevil, and Deadly Arts. Weakening Strikes, Escapist Absolution, and Lotus Train. That's actually pretty good, but he's got power weapons.
Well, Dagger Pistol Staff, he's got Potent Poison, though.
Yeah, I mean, but the poison's not probably not gonna do much unless he goes mercenary. Maybe he goes mercenary actually.
Yeah.
I mean, mercenary or if he go. Imagine if he goes vipers. Just imagine that situation.
Oh yes, please do. I'd be sick.
Yeah. Imagine if he does that. But yeah, he will have lots of cleanse to deal with the conditions from Planix. I mean, because he has whenever he dodges, he gets a cleanse every 1 second. That's pretty good.
That is pretty good.
Yeah, he's got Basilisk Venom. He's got Bandit's Defense. Really good block. And he has the trap with the trap trait.
Wow.
That is going to give him some might, and it will apply... I think it just makes the durations better, I think. Let me just check that, actually.
Ogden's Hammer.
Oh, no. No, it just applies vulnerability and grants might, and that's 20% reduced cooldown. And then, yeah, and then he has better poison because of potent poison. And dagger training, and he has a dagger. So he can poison people. Wow. Yeah. Oh, I don't know. I mean, Acrobatics could be pretty handy here because it's going to give him a lot of extra dodging because Vigor is better on him. And he'll get Vigor whenever he evades. He's got permanent Vigor because he's a Daredevil. He's going to be evading all over the place. He's going crazy. Instant Reflexes. This trait's actually pretty good. Whenever you go below 50%, it gives you 2 seconds of evasion, which is basically invulnerability. Which is, you know, that's pretty good. And Assassin's Reward, it's actually, it might be pretty good, honestly. I mean, he can use initiative pretty effectively with, I mean, he's got Vault, which he's going to want to spam quite a lot. He has a bunch of skills he's going to want to use a lot. And that will also give him some ability. Because, I mean, when he uses Vault, he evades, so he gets a little bit of health while evading, which is always very good. So Vault will heal him for about 500.
Well, the thing is, he hasn't got any thieves, and that's good for him, because Giordano has Rise.
Yeah. Rise? Yeah, so it's going to summon 2 guys for him, isn't it?
Yeah, not so good, but if he gets through this round, it could become insanely strong in other ones, especially against the Mesmer, if he gets there at the end.
Yeah.
Be a lot of little fuckers.
There are a lot of little fuckers. And he's got Corrupt Boon as well, which is really helpful. It will turn the Vigor into Weakness, I think. And the Swiftness into Cripple. Consume Conditions is going to be handy, seeing as Ganloss will be applying Condies. Just by dodging. Let's see, what else is going on here? Plenix is here, I think. Yes, he is.
Better be.
He is here. Hmm. And the weapons are a bit weird. Although Scepter Warhorn's a really nice combo, but Dagger Focus is kind of, you know, it's pretty meh.
Yeah, it's just kind of okay.
He wants staff. He wanted staff, you know, that's what he wanted. But I mean, having Death Magic, he's going to have some resistance to Condies with Shrouded Removal and Corruptor's Fervor and so on. More Boonstrip with Path of Corruption. Sustain with Parasitic Contagion. Although it's going to be very difficult for Planet to actually get any work done.
Oh my god, his opponent went Vipers.
Yeah. Oh, is he going? Is Ganlos going YOLO?
Yeah. He's going Viper's Berserker, even better.
Wow. This is a bold statement.
And two Sigils of Doom. He's got Doom, Geomancy, Doom, and Leeching.
This is pretty ballsy for Ganlos here. I mean, this is the guy who wants to hunt down random user and kill him. You have to bear that in mind. Will it work, though? I don't know, Kevin. I don't know, Kev. What the hell is this? Well, I mean, it lives up to his name, doesn't he? He's a very fat Norn.
Small fat Norn.
Is he small? I can't really tell.
No, Norn are pretty small, but...
Yeah. Ah, Innie is here as well. Excellent. He's going for Mercenary, bit of a hybrid strat. Pretty sensible, given that he has the dagger, especially given that he has the dagger. And Rune of the Soldier. So, these shouts now cleanse a condition as well. Could be good.
Yeah, it could be.
It could be good. It does depend how much, how many Condies are going to go and play. It's quite interesting that he's gone for Superior Sigil Speed here. I guess he's going to go for a really fast Boon Corrupt with Focus 5 when he swaps over to it. And then Energy and Doom here for more dodges than Hydromancy. So he does want to get some Chill, which obviously is good for him, seeing as he has Deathly Chill. But, yeah.
Deathliest of Chills.
Let's see if Ganlos can YOLO his way to victory. I'm honestly not sure how good this is for him.
No.
He'll be dodging a lot, so it'll be difficult to hit him, but... He's got... Look at his health bar! It's already gone!
Yeah, he has no health. There's Ryze.
Hey, there's the Basilisk.
Little fuckers. It's not doing anything.
He tries to put the trap down. The thing is, he's... Oh, no! He gets stunned! What a disaster! He's going Bandit's Defense Block. Can he get the knockdown? He does have the kick. Oh, but it's evaded by Plenix. And Ganlos is not having a good time right now. That high HP bar of the Necro is pretty good against Condies. Although Consume Conditions has been used here. The heal is up for Ganlos, but he's basically dead. In fact, he is dead.
Yeah.
He's completely screwed. Although, it was close. Look, in the end, it was close.
It was, because Consume Conditions is going to make sure he doesn't die. Huh?
Oh, he's not done yet. He's going to go for a stealth attack. Oh, get stomped from the low ground.
Looks sort of like a big blue communist, Giordano. Look at him.
Massive communist.
If he were red, he would be a true communist. That furry coat and his little hat.
Planix takes the first game here by using Scepter auto attack. Pretty good. Ganlos just go face SM Orc. Yeah. I don't know what you should switch to. Do you think you should just switch to Zerka and just try and go power?
Or yeah, more, definitely.
Because I think if you can get some dirty vaults off, it might be more effective. Because right now, trying to use some of his Condi traits. Oh, he's going for Mercenaries. So he's turned it down a little bit. Yeah. Interesting. Yeah. 7-6-1 Heartseeker, yeah. Not gonna do much. I don't know. I mean, he's trying to make the Lotus training and the Dagger training and the traps get some work done for him, but I just don't think it can, really. You know? I'm just not sure if it can. With the poison trait. I'm not convinced. Not convinced, Kevin. Yes,
he just needs a dagger poison tray, but he didn't get it.
But he does have it.
No, not that one. Which one am I thinking of? I think I might think of Ranger, actually. It's been too long since I played Thief.
Okay. I think he's still thinking.
No, offhand dagger, rather. That's what he needs.
Where's Planix gone? Planix is just... What is he even doing? He actually does...
Should we stop saying Kevin, do you reckon?
Kevin? Why do we want to stop saying Kevin?
I don't know, Kevin.
Can we link to Kevin on the wiki?
Yeah, someone go link Kevin.
Link the page. Where is... He can't have rage quit. Because he actually won that game. I don't know. Oh, he's choosing a different rune. Oh, he doesn't want to give his opponent the opportunity to see it, I think. Yeah. Yeah, I didn't really have a problem with his room. But I have no idea. I think Soldier was a pretty solid choice, honestly. Wiki.google/Kevin.
Kevin, there you go. Kevin.
Kevin.
And the link to Kevin.
There's the link to Kevin. Superior Sigil of Grawl Slaying.
Oh, slay Grawls with your Kevin.
Yeah.
What's the story behind Kevin? I don't know, Kevin.
I don't know, Kev. I don't start the game. Unless I get really bored. Look, he's just, what is he choosing? How many runes are there? He's probably checked every single one now. Maybe. What do you reckon he's going to go for? Is he going to go for Lissa for the extra cleanse? Or maybe he's going to go aggressive. Like, maybe Crate or Afflicted or something.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah. I don't know. Oh, wait, what? I'm not sure about this.
I don't know, Kevin.
I don't know. Clerics. I'm not sure if this is going to work. Mm. He'll never be able to kill his opponent with clerics. Although, how much does this heal him? Look, this heals him.
Valkyrie? Sage.
No, he's just trolling at this point. He's just trolling. Menders, so he gets extra healing. Look at how much healing this is. Holy shit.
And Berserker.
Back to Berserker. This is so ballsy. Ganlos, YOLO to the end.
Mm.
Is he going to stick with it, though? I don't know.
I don't know.
No, he's going to go with Nightmares, just more duration. So, kind of fear. The fear is that you can really kind of trigger people sometimes. It can be really annoying.
Yeah.
But other than that, it's the same setup here for Planics. And now he's going Marauder. Okay. They can go when ready now. So maybe now the vault spam will come into play and start wrecking everyone.
Yeah.
Yeah. That blue outfit. Yeah. It's a shame. Imagine if he had Dagger. This is totally different, right? Because he can just spam the evades and probably just grind Plenix down. However, not over yet. Ganlos is a powerful foe. Let's see if he can win. Get one back on the board. I guess the poison will now be mainly for suppressing healing, as it won't do a great deal of damage anymore. Well, you know, 1k damage on a steel. Yeah, it could be worse, right?
Tag Dagger versus Noob Crow. See you later.
Yeah.
Wow. I mean, Daredevil, sorry, on Tag Dagger. I'm so used to seeing DD as like a fucking dagger ready.
And there we go. The trap gets down from the Basilisk Venom. Ganlos, what a meme god.
Yeah, he
does. However, he doesn't manage to dodge.
Yeah,
I think it's that shout will take all his health away. That's the problem.
Yeah, but he's healing up again. He's healing
he gets a pretty big heal, but he needs to dodge this stun. Oh, no! The dodge timing.
Oh, doesn't quite get it.
What a disaster.
Now
yeah, he's dead. Fast. It's GG. He's dead. He's completely done. There's no way. Disaster. Yeah. Oh, wow. That was disastrous. He got hit by both of the key abilities, unfortunately.
And Daredevil down. Well,
that was a little bit unfortunate.
Wait, why is Panic being salty? He just won.
He just won? Why is he salty? He won the game.
Oh, I can't reach
So, Ganlos falls. He won't be killing random user today. But maybe someone else will. His hunt is over for this season at least. And now we can do Jingyi versus Innie because Innie has returned. So let's go ahead and do that. The one druid. I'll be interested to see if these pets are actually wrong. Because the pet might be wrong because the other ones were. Although it didn't seem like they were.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah.
Alright, here we go. It's the one druid. We've already been over these, haven't we?
Yeah, we've been over these. But, I mean,
they should definitely just kill
each
other.
I'll fix it in editing. That's what will happen.
Alright, fix it in editing.
Good. It's going to be amazing. It's gonna be terrific. Gonna be terrific. Make Mystic Builds gray again.
Maybe this was gray. They're are they ready to fight? Oh my god, the ugly face is back.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. The pets were wrong.
Oh, they were wrong. Okay, so it's the
Griffin
thingy.
Yeah.
The dragon. Oh yeah, healing turn and adaptive armor. This might not end.
Yeah. So, innate with a scrapper. I mean, these are both pretty good things to have in a 1v1 tournament. I mean, this could never end, honestly.
This could potentially never end.
Yes. Not as potentially. But the electric wyvern. Look how overpowered this is. If I go in here, launch 0, damage 1. This is clearly pretty strong here.
Yeah, 1 damage, it doesn't launch them at all. They just don't move.
1 damage? Well, launch 0 is...
Ah,
oh,
damage now.
Oh,
still
shit.
There's still no launch, though.
Yeah.
I kind of wish it just didn't launch. Like, and they had that on every single skill, it didn't launch. Launch 0, thanks to that. Mm. It's better to not launch.
The giant celestial avatar. What a weird bug.
Oh, that is so annoying, actually, because you can't see your... At least when I'm playing it, I can't see my bar properly, so I don't know when my celestial avatar is going to come up.
Rip.
Colin, fix it.
Colin, oh wait.
Oh wait a second.
Yeah.
All right, going in a bit of early
here we
stuff.
Go. Oh no, reflects the rapid fire back onto himself by the Scrapperino. And here comes the scrap. Oh no, misses Thunderclap. That's a little bit unfortunate.
Nice dodge back of his slick
shoes. But the slick shoes.
Oh, that's so annoying.
The
what
rocket
can you
charge.
Do? He's getting stunned.
The memes. Things are happening. Elixir gun for a bit of weakness.
Ah, the other pet is one of the drakes.
Marsh
so it's
drake.
It's going to have a poison breath.
Oh. And doesn't this guy put a poison field down?
Yeah, he does. Yeah, poison. Oh, is he a field, though?
I'm not sure. But the thunderclap into the combo. That is a very powerful meme. And the scrapper emerges victorious.
God, this reminds me of World v. World, actually. The way that scrapper's fighting. Rest in peace, Wealthy World.
Slick shoes. That is a good ability, if ever I've seen one. Okay, that is a nice ability. Mm. Yeah. Electro Whirl and Rocket Charge, the real MVP. So this is Marauder, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Oh. That's a lot of damage. Marauder Scrapper is the best.
It is.
Knights is Cancer. Marauder is good. Knights Scrapper. Not Knights. Paladin rather. Paladin is Phil's bad man. Marauder is Phil's good man.
Yep.
So. Let's find out what happens. This is an unhappy druid right now. You can't. The thing is with the zoom, I can't zoom in that close.
Without going in, like, completely in, yeah.
Yeah. That's quite unfortunate. You can't get a good look at that face.
If he ran to a wall, you could, but. They're gonna kill each other now, so they don't have a chance to do that.
Rune of the Ranger. Interesting.
Role playing as a ranger.
Yeah, this is some nice role play if you think about it. Yeah.
Rune of the Ranger is pretty sick if you think about it, when you're a ranger, obviously. Because you always have an active companion, like, every single time. 7% damage.
Rampage and Elixir X are banned. Reduce field of view. That's a smart thing you could do, Axel. But I
not that desperate to zoom in the face.
Yeah, I don't. Okay, we're gonna do this fight in minimum field of view. Here we go. This actually looks really weird. Oh my god. So here we have the scrapper going in for the attack, taking a lot of damage though. The staff is whittling him down. The Thundercup does land, but no combo really executed there. However, the Scrapper's got a lot of tricks left, and Jingy doesn't have a lot of health left. There is the Electro Whirl, but that doesn't actually reflect anything this time. Does the Supply Crate land? It does, and here comes the Rocket Charge!
Oh,
will that be it?
Smash,
and it will be. Function Gyro will secure the kill. Oh no, it got interrupted, so no it won't. Looks like hammer attacks are going to seal the deal. May my hammer eat your face, says Inny.
Not my face.
And Inny wins 2-0 there. Blue team grabbed a capture point. There you go. This field of view is actually really messing with my eyes. I need to change this shit back. Ugh. Ugh! There we go. It's better. So let's see. I think Rim is back, isn't he? I'm pretty sure he's back. Let's find out. Because we should do Nick Sully versus Rim. Right now.
Alright.
Nick Sully is here. And Rim is here. Perfect. And everything is going fine now. I mean, we can briefly look at the builds. Oh, no, that's us. Never mind. The Druid versus the Signet Deathly Soul Decimate Reaper. How about that? I mean, there's a lot of condition cancer for Nick Sully here, kind of, with all the Signets. I mean, Signet of Spite is memes. Plague Signet, all the conditions from all the poison and bleeding from the daggers, that's going to go straight back to Rim. Even the immobilized from the Ancient Seeds and stuff. But how useful will those signets be without the trait? No idea. Yeah. I don't know. Okay, yeah. Rim is here, and Nixily is here as well. I know that. He'll be here shortly. So let's just jump into the games and see what's happening here. Rim is going for Melandru Marauder. With Leeching Hydromancy Air Generosity.
Classic.
Yeah, it's a pretty solid setup here. Generosity might not even be necessary. I mean, he's got Druidic Clarity, so all Condi's gone when he goes Celestial. And he's got nice heal as well. Troll Ungent, you know, 8.5k heal, which is obviously, you know, the synergy with Druid, right? Because it charges up very effectively, because it's 10 packets. That's very effective. And stuff like natural healing as well.
Yep.
It will charge up your memes. I believe, yeah, it does. Oh. Wait, does he have the... Yeah, he has Resounding Tombra, but he doesn't. He does have a shout as well, so he gets two shouts, so he gets extra regen as well. Which, yeah. I mean, regen is what you want with the Druid, because it charges up your avatar memes.
So he's got Garb with the Bear, which is actually one of the better pets to have it with. It's so goddamn tanky.
Yeah.
Although most pets have a lot of HP.
And the Bear can also get rid of some conditions. It's AoE cleanse, isn't it? Shake it off. But you know, you gotta just look at the bear's face. Hang on, can we get a...
Oh, I love this
look
bear.
At him. Look at him. Just beautiful.
The bear is like the best.
He's cool. I will fook you up as well. That's a good name.
Well, as long as he's not swearing. Name.
Yeah.
Here goes the bear. This isn't really Nick Sully versus Rim. This is Nick Sully versus the bear.
Yes. If he kills the bear, that counts as a win.
Yep. Here goes the bear. I'm just zooming in the bear's face that runs along. God, that's so stupid.
Things are happening. But how long will they happen for? A lot of conditions coming out from Nick Sully. I mean, the staff is a very powerful weapon. Do not underestimate it. My field of view is still too small. Hang on. That's a bit better. And there's a Reaper Shroud 4. Very, very dangerous ability indeed. Nick Sully's still camping the staff, though. Interestingly. Not going to go for the dagger or to maybe get rid of some of those boons with the focus. Interesting. And he is dropping in health now. Does still have access to his heal and the Shout of Doom, though. Now he's going to go for the dagger. Tries to get the stun, but I think Rim had mass stability at the time.
Yep.
So that doesn't do anything. Does have his almost second heal skill. Oh, imagine if he'd interrupted that heal. That would have been absolutely huge if he got the Reaper's Mark. But unfortunately, he doesn't. That's 8 stacks of poison. He needs to transfer that. Oh, no. He didn't
and
transfer.
He's not going to manage it. He's at it. He didn't give a fuck.
Yeah. He's
Black Hole just barely misses. Dodges last second.
It's actually getting pretty close right now. Yeah, Chillblains could do huge damage right now. And it does land. Oh, actually, no, it didn't.
It
almost did. That's kind of... No! He could have gone into Shroud to try and survive, but... Fortunately, he was not able to do so. And Rim will kill him. Gonna be... He's 1-0 up. Will he BM? I don't know.
I don't know. Let's see.
Yeah. I mean, as we can see, Druid is not a problem. That was a close game. Yeah, that was pretty close.
I like people using Druid as an offensive thing.
It's Traherne's sword, look. It actually goes very well with this Druid, actually.
Broken Cairn, or whatever it's called.
Rim at 20% HP. I look away for 2 seconds. 90% Dan's game.
Oh, the Bears are back in chat. Oh, no. All right, just because the final, the Bears can stay. Just okay. Make sure they don't throw anything.
The Bears are allowed. Oh, wait, no, they should be because they're cheering on. They're contender,
as long,
aren't
as
they?
Long as, yeah, as long as the Bears, you know, are part of the crowd, then they can stay.
Well, no, they're cheering on the Bear.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, they're perfectly able to belong.
Exactly. They have a. They're being represented. Look at. What is this animation? What's it looking at? It's just looking up there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, look at it.
Yeah.
Just look at the camera.
Here we go again. And they bring him out. Did he change anything? Oh! It's YOLO. Oh, wait, was he already YOLO?
I don't feel like he was.
Did we even check his memes? Maybe he was YOLO the entire time.
I think we didn't notice if he was YOLO. We definitely checked something on him.
Maybe he was YOLO. Yeah, he didn't... was he mercenary? Maybe he was mercenary, and now he's bored.
Possibly, yeah.
And this could work out for him pretty well, because Rim only has one big cleanse, which is when he goes Avatar. I think. Oh, wait, he has the dodge thing, which and that gets rid of, what, poison, I think? Poison, cripple, and blind, yeah. Hmm. If he can land... land something like a big Reaper Shroud 5, that's going to hurt a lot. And actually, this is going pretty effectively. He uses the Locust, transfers all those memes back. Oh, Putrid Mark, yeah. That's a transfer, don't do that. But will it matter? Signet of Spike goes down. If he can land this stun... Oh, but wait, no. He's got fucking a million...
He's not going to land
the
stun, but
a squillion stacks of stability.
These four stacks of bleeding might just kill him. He's really close to dying.
What? Nick Tully! Heal! Heal!
Heal! Gets the heal off.
Okay, that was.
Is he gonna go? He can't really hit him because he has daggers.
He should use life siphon on the bear, right?
Oh, that'd be genius, yeah. Oh, but the bear is just going crazy.
The bear is just going crazy on him.
Oh, but he escapes the bear.
Okay, he needs to run. Nixley, run away! What are you doing? He's bored.
Yeah, he's had enough. He's just.
He's had enough.
Yep. 2v1.
Rim's gonna BM now as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, he left.
He's done it.
Take my energy, bear. There you go. Rim takes a 2-0 here. Wait, what does that even say? 1500 range. Oh, yeah. But, wait, he doesn't have 1500 range, though. He only has 1200. He doesn't have longbow, does he? No, he doesn't. Yeah. There you go. We're getting some pretty quick matches here. So there's the thing.
Clown Fiesta.
There's a bit of a Clown Fiesta, isn't it? Anyway. Let's see. What are we doing now? I've no idea. Let's find out. It has to be Felon versus random user. But let's see if Felon is here. No! Of all people, random user will receive a free win.
Oh.
So that's pretty entertaining. Let's see if Nasir has arrived. No. So actually, though Nasir did tell me, so we'll actually do the round of 8 now instead. So I guess we might as well start from the bottom, seeing as Red Naxxler hasn't played. We'll do Saihan versus Red Naxxler.
All right, let's go.
Let's see about this. Oh, another Reaper here for Red Naxxler. Of course, we've already seen Saihan's Dragon Hunter build, but how will it fare against a Reaper?
Oh, okay. So, the big idea with the Dragon Hunter is it's going to want to block everything. So the main thing it's going to beat it is small attacks, but frequent or conditions.
Oh, you know what? You know what's even better? Having nothing can save you that makes you unblockable.
Oh, yeah.
Although... you won't get much duration on it because it will only be hitting one target, but still. And it also strips boons as well. It turns them into vulnerability rather than stripping boons. So actually, pretty powerful stuff here from Red Naxxler. Quite effective against what Saihan has. Obviously having Plague Signet's very nice. There'll be a little bit of burning, maybe blind. They can get transferred back. But there are some very useful boons to get corrupted for Red Naxxler here. Having Aegis corrupted or Retaliation corrupted is a pretty big deal. And it's not going to be good. He has traited consumed conditions as well. That's going to help him out a lot down the line. So that's good. He has Augury of Death, so the two shouts he has will get extra value, which is really, really nice. The cooldown will be reduced considerably on those. The 10% and then the 5% for the one target. So 15% cooldown reduction on shouts, pretty good. And they also steal life, so that's very handy. Decimate defenses with Axe, Bitter Chill, and Rending Shroud. So that's, honestly, that's probably going to be about 25 stacks of vulnerability on his opponent all time. All time, so 50% extra crit.
Oh, that's going to be nasty, yeah.
And then Deathly Chill, also pretty powerful. Oh, Lingering Curse with a Scepter. That's very, very nice. And with Plague Sending, too. This is a nice build here for Red Nexler, I think. Especially against Saihan. This is going to be difficult. Yeah. I have to see. But I guess we might as well leap into it. Let's see what manner of memes Red Nax was preparing. They're on the opposite teams, so bear that in mind.
Yep.
Actually, I need to do the bets, because people actually bet on one of those games. I can't remember which game it was, though. Oh, yeah, this one. There we go. Okay, here we go. Grenth and Mercenary. So using consumed conditions will do an AoE chill. Pretty powerful. And with 50% duration, it lasts for 4.5 seconds.
That's pretty long.
And then Ice Doom. Frailty and Ice here. So extra chill. Trying to maintain that.
Oh, random may have to commit Sudoku here.
Oh, no.
Yeah, there you go. He's done it.
Wait, very what honorable. Happened? What very happened?
He put a capital E in Kipo in it, you know. He didn't show up. Well, he did commit Sudoku, though. Rest in peace.
Yeah. Okay, here we go. Something is happening. Scepter will continuously corrupt. If he could corrupt that. Oh no! He corrupted the stability. Turned it into fear. The nightmare has happened.
Do anything.
However, you can't do anything against the courage memes. And Saihan is getting some good work done here. Yeah. Goes with the shield. Block some of the projectiles that Red Nexler doesn't have. And a sword 3 does some big damage here as well.
Yeah. Here with that.
Protector Strike, a very powerful ability there, and Shelter. Oh, if only he had. Thing is, that's what you want to save the Shield 5 for, right? You want to save the Shield 5 to interrupt the heal.
Yeah, exactly.
So you don't really want to use it, but that's a lot of conditions that just got applied.
Yeah, but he's gonna,
and
he's
Saiyan
gonna
can't really do anything about that. He's going to put a trap down, but use the Shield 5 again, so now he doesn't have an interrupt for the heal.
I don't think that's his biggest concern right now, to be honest.
He needs to go for the full heal, right?
Oh, he doesn't get it. He's not going to.
Yeah. 1040 Axe 2. Big damage.
Well.
Random's paying a lot. He's betting just as Saihan dies. That's very cheeky. Although. Oh, no, wait, no, he didn't fuck it up. No, wait, he did fuck it up!
He's got an exclamation mark. Now he has to commit Sudoku and.
No. He messed it up. He bet on. I think he was probably trying to bet on Red Naxler, but.
Wait, he was? Shit.
He bet on Saihan by accident.
You might want to refund him on that one.
No, I will never refund you.
Wait, can I just bet 600 on the other side and Sunday as well? Okay.
Well, you can't bet anymore.
You can only bet once now? Oh, I thought you could do multiple bets before.
No, you can only bet once there's no points.
Oh, shit, yeah. He just got scammed! Wow.
Yeah, scammers.
Scammers.
All right, they're on the wrong. They're on. Looks like they're gonna be in the right colors this time. Saihan honestly nearly won there.
Yeah.
Error. Team not. Oh yeah, he refuses to go on a color that isn't blue.
Oh, what a clown. So it's a fucking Royale roll. There you go.
Solution found. Do you win now? Wait, what? The match starts soon. Here we go. Scarmaz. Oh wow, Minty Fresh has got 3,007 clovers. Let's see.
3,000. Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's a good amount. Cyan nearly won there. He could do it.
Yeah, random uses back. It'd still be legitimate.
It could still be legit. You got to do it for random, Cyan. If you lose, random loses 300 clovers. You really want that to happen?
What do you think he does?
Or a random user. Can't just take his clovers away. Okay, he's going in. He's got the shield from the Shield of Wrath. Gets a pull, but he puts the trap down second. That's the wrong order. Never mind. Got the bulwark. Wait, no, Shield of Courage, isn't it? Red Naxxar is doing a lot better this time, though. And Saihan is in a lot of trouble here. Did he go more? No, it's the same build. It's the same setup. But it's just not really working out for Saihan this time. Maybe it really is the color. He just can't deal with it. Can he get... Oh, he's going for the big heal. Look, he's actually going to get it here as well, I think. Hmm. Yeah, there you go. He gets full heal.
Yeah, quite nice.
And he can get the trap down. It will spin around wildly and do good damage. But he didn't actually have a dodge there available. And he will fall.
Yeah.
To Red Naxxar. Bleep bloop. Bleeb bloob.
Oh.
Red Naxxar will take the second game there. Which feels bad. Well, if you're him anyway. But I don't know. Maybe it feels good, man, for Red Naxxar, because he is moving on to face someone in the future. We'll go back up the bracket. So now we're going to do Rim versus Axel Warrior.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, this is a very spoopy match. Chrono versus Druid. I think Axel has the advantage here. His Condi Ebola with the mower is just repulsive.
It is. Very repulsive.
I think he made a good call going for Mesmer.
I signed Random's ban for some reason.
Oh, really?
Yeah, there we go.
Why did he get banned?
It was all for roleplay to make sure the chat has some action. Teapot won't get banned for viewbotting.
Beep, boop. Beep, boop. Okay. So, here we go. The Druid versus the Mental Images Illusions Chronomancer. You know, all these things are accurate, right? Because Axel has a mind, so he's mental. He has images. He does exist. He's a picture. And the illusions. He's a mesmer. Of course he has illusions.
Yeah, obviously. Of course he
has. It's a shame he has that mantra heal. Obviously, the dream is Aether Feast. But honestly, the well will be pretty good as well. I feel like the mantra... Although then again, given that he has inspiration, maybe it's not so bad. He's going to get some... He's going to get condition cleanse value out of that, isn't he?
Yeah.
In fact, maybe the mantra is good, because he can get lots of cleanse from power from Mender's Purity.
Yeah, he can...
Interesting.
I don't know, though.
Maybe.
Mantras without third mantra thing.
Yeah, it's just interesting. Oh, you know the funny thing about that Minty Fresh? I think that actually works if you do the quotations because of the way int.pars works. But let's get this started. You are Axel Acceleration. Rim going with Marauder Melandrew, the good old setup. And again, Mercenary Nightmare here for Axel. Very standard setup. Charges up his mantra, and he's ready to go. Oh, wait, is Random User banned? Oh, wait, no, I think it's just chat is...
Chat is rioting.
It's just rioting, yeah.
Yeah.
Unban Random User or Riot? Ban Random User or Riot. You've got two different opinions there. Axel, you are our only hope. I'm surprised that Random's threatened by this build, because honestly, I don't think Rim's build has panned out quite as he intended. I mean, it's decent, but I'm not sure it can beat Axel here.
No, I mean,
I think there's too much Ebola from him, I think.
There is it's just an Ebola fiesta.
I mean, I think he has been a little bit unfortunate with RNG. I mean, again, he's going to abuse terrain, and we've seen how powerful that can be.
Hmm.
But will it be enough? Do it, Bear. Okay, oh, of course,
the
Bear's
back. Yeah, the Bear support.
Yeah. How about we both drop? Oh. Huh. Arcane Thievery could be good here, because Rim's going to have a lot of boons. Oh shit, the Rune of the Nightmare, Brock. This is intense. Why doesn't he just go round? Why does he... you know?
Yeah, it could just... Oh, off they go.
Axel does like playing hide and seek. Does anyone play Revenant in this tournament? I believe there is a Revenant, yes. And you'll see that when it happens. Okay. It's beginning. There goes the Avenger from the shield. Does get summoned there. And there's a lot of damage coming through. And there's a mower. But Rim, being the smart man that he is, he does know how to get away as a mower. Although there will be a bit of free damage here. Although not much. Really well played there by Rim. Really juking the fuck out of Axel there. And he's going to use his superior mobility to try and get some work done here. Another confused beam is ready to go. And that's 10 stacks confusion. That hurts. However, Celestial Avatar deals with that pretty quickly, as you would imagine.
Yeah.
And here we go. It's a lot. I think Axel does have a lot of damage. Awful lot of damage. Yeah, but Rim does seem to be able just to get away pretty easily. Gets the stun, though. Blood Frenzy. Oh, yeah, but the thing is, Rim has a lot of stability, so he didn't actually get the stun. Never mind. And this could be Resident Sleeper.
Yeah, this is not looking like it's going anywhere, really.
Not yet. Maybe a big shatter can change things, but Rim does seem to be able to just get away here.
Yeah, he's just kind of leaving and then healing. He's got another Trollinger, which is a lot of healing.
Super speed on clones will be useful in this. Well, he does actually have that. As you can see, time catches up. Which is a pretty strong trait, honestly. Although I think some people actually really like delayed reactions. But, yeah. Hard to say.
You can do whatever you want, really.
Yeah, now Rim's going on the offensive, but I mean, does he have the damage to kill Axel? I mean, Axel has a lot of things he can do to not die.
He's kind of got another power turn, still waiting to go, in fact.
Yeah, there's more confusion going out. However, there's the block. Oh, I know, he's not going to go for it. Yeah, there it is. Applies 5 stacks of torment. However, Rim will just heal up immediately. He'll just go Avatar and then immediately heal. The only way that he dies is if he gets mowed and stunned or something.
Yeah.
Oh, there's another mantra. Okay, he gets a big shield stunnerino. Very, very useful there. And Rim does seem unable to really contend with Axel here. He's getting chased down, but then Avatar's going to heal him up again. Honestly, this could end. Going to get another confusing images off. Only 3 stacks, though, so not particularly great. But the mower is going to be up soon. Blurred Frenzy with the Immobilized from Illusionary Leap. That's very nice. He's going to go for a dirty block. And the mower is up in 8 seconds. Well, the Rim will be paying attention. He'll know it's coming for sure.
Yeah, that's on the heat. Yeah, this is going to end.
It has to end right now. Is he going to go for even going to try, or is he just going to run away? Oh, this doesn't end. Yeah.
Oh, Fiesta. So, are they going to have to change? We currently have Merc versus Marauder, so...
Oh, wow. Imagine if he gets him down now. That would be unbelievable, but it's not going to happen. So, they're going to have to go one defensive meme, I guess. But wait, Rim already has that. Fuck.
Zero, then? Both go to zero?
I don't know what the solution to this is, actually. Maybe they're just not allowed to run away, but then, I don't know, actually.
I think both go YOLO, to be honest.
Both YOLO?
Yeah, pretty funny, at least. I think I just like people going YOLO.
Well, Axel's going... Well, the thing is, though, I think it would really screw Axel. Wait, Saihan's in now. What the fuck?
What?
What is this role-playing? Yeah, it's 1-1, because that's the tie.
YOLO or NOLO?
Leap, bloop. YOLO or NOLO? Fight at the middle? Thing is, if they go one defensive, what does Axel switch to? What does he go to?
Carrion, apparently.
Okay. That doesn't really hurt him that much then, actually. Let's see how it works out.
Yeah.
Because he has more condition damage. Might still be Resident Sleeper.
Maybe.
Fired up. Fight Lord Rush. Let's see how Axel will fare now that he is carrying Rim still with Marauder. Yeah, Mercenary is pretty overpowered. If you think about the stats it gives more stats than Carrion. Pretty easily, I think. Is it, maybe it gives the same, actually. But it gives you a better spread of stats, I think.
Yeah. Marauder is just like... It's just the prettiest, you know, it's the one you go for. Oh, yeah. Random user fails an SM Orc and again commits Sudoku.
SM Orc.
There goes the bear.
The bear, in it goes.
Go. The bear, it's going to reach. Oh, and the bear attacks.
Here comes Axel. Will he be able to get anything done here? He's going to probably get a big mind rack. Yep, he does. Oh. Is he going to try for a mower? He'll probably go stun mower with the... Maybe? Okay. Oh, he gets the... Oh, he doesn't get the stun because of stability. So, nothing is really happening.
Again, nothing. Yeah, this is not good. Not too good, actually.
Yeah. He doesn't even get the block. Rim is... He's wide awake. He's paying attention. But, you know, he does have a lot of... Axel does have a lot of survivability. You know, he can do all these crazy blocks, you know?
He can, but...
Continuum Rift. Goes for the mower. Nice. Successfully gets the mower and immobilizes Rim here. He's going to be able to get some very nice memes here. Very likely. The mower is now gone.
The Celestial Avatar's back in there.
Yeah, he didn't Continuum Split it either, so he doesn't get a second mower. Although he might get a big cry of frustration here. And
ooh, maybe.
No,
he doesn't.
Yeah, I think it got instantly cleansed, so that doesn't do shit. I think this is Resident Sleeper again. I'm not sure if they can kill each other.
It's not really getting anywhere.
Yeah. I really don't think this does anything. I mean, he can just keep doing this forever, probably. If he just goes back to shield, he's gonna be fine.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, maybe he's not.
He's immune to. Now he's got heal again. So, any question is whether Rim can, you know, interrupt him or something. And that will not be the case.
Maybe he's not fine.
No, I think he is. Although he's got 2 minutes survive, so maybe not.
Yeah, maybe he's not okay. He should probably use that to transfer some of those memes.
Yeah.
But Axel is in a lot of trouble right now. Things are happening. However, Rim is also very low as well. Mm. And that Mantra Heal is pretty good. And did he interrupt something important there? I think he did. Oh no, wait. The Troll Engine did go off. Still has one more power return. Gets an Immobilize. Blurred Frenzy. He's going to get two blocks here again, as well of Calamity. The stun is pretty worthless because of all the stability that Rim has. If only he could steal some of that would be pretty good.
Good enough.
Yeah, actually, he needs to run here. He definitely needs to run. He needs to get out. If he can channel this, that would be very nice for him. He's going to get another two mantras.
Yeah, he's going to use... Not a block. Saving it.
Confuse Beam goes... And he's got more blocks and Blurred Frenzy to evade something. Another block. Can he get the shield? He does get a successful stun there. And will he be able to channel another Mantra meme? He will, and Rim is pretty low. Wait, oh, he nearly managed to interrupt that, but he just didn't. Confuse Beam. Oh, 7 stacks of confusion. That really that really hurts.
That does hurt, but...
Yeah, that's pretty brutal, honestly. As well as Calamity. Axel... He's looking like he might be able to finish this. Maybe. Maybe if he lands Moa while Rim is not on full health, it might work, you know?
He's got 1 minute to do it.
Yeah. Oh. Ooh. Ooh. just die already. Nice roleplay. So they will be forced to go full YOLO after this.
Why is Krybus banned?
Stop. Don't ban. Well, Van Muser here, and he'll wield the hammer on Reddit. Yeah, you don't want to go too crazy. Otherwise, it'll take away your fake internet points. Well, this is Resident Sleeper. It would appear, anyway. Yeah. Keep running, Baby Rage. You're better off without the Reddit.
Without the Reddit.
Yeah. Cyan ain't even posting there. Oh well. Only get headaches. And there you go. Nothing happened. So.
YOLO.
YOLO time.
It's gotta be.
Yep. So I guess it'll be Viper for Axel. Probably. You want to ban everyone who criticizes you? You're basically Hitler? Well, I don't think I'd go that far, but don't worry, I didn't ban you. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, it wasn't us. We very much welcome criticism of Mystic Bills because we want to make it better.
Exactly.
You know?
So now I'm going to be YOLO. Rim will probably go, well, he'll definitely go Berserker. What am I talking about? And Axel, I'd say 90% Vipers right now.
Yeah, gotta be.
I'd say, oh well. Alright, let's just check. And what's it going to be? Mm-hmm. Mame the Disillusion, yeah. Well. He's going Viper. And Rim, he's still on Marauder. What will he go for? What rules? Okay, there we go. He is... The YOLO Fiesta is about to begin. Who does this favor? I mean, maybe Axel, if he can get the MOA, he's better off. But I think this is pretty even.
Yes.
Let's see.
Yeah, they both came fairly close to dying previously, so...
Yeah. This might be that little bit that it needs for each of them to push it over the edge. I mean, I really wouldn't want to call this. I think this is a fairly even match right here.
Mm.
I mean, maybe it's now... Now it's not even because of this giant celestial avatar, but...
You know. Yeah. The larger celestial avatar, the better it is.
Yeah, you know, I mean, you win, you know? The better it is, the more you win.
See, it says conditions remove 13, but it only does that if it's large.
Of course, yeah.
If it's small, it just doesn't read it. So.
Good news! Chat fixed itself.
Hooray!
So I can put it back now.
Great work,
there
chat.
I think there was just a little bit of a problem with the Twitch API there. As I told Cyan anyway, they are...
No. Didn't you see? The bears are fixing it in chat. They found it so useful. They whacked on the hammers and just sort of... Chat guide, it's Twitch chat, go crazy. Yeah, absolutely. We do not condone banning at all here. If anyone ever gets banned, it's usually a joke.
Yeah, if you get banned and the guy forgets to unban you, just whisper one of the mods and they'll unban you.
Yep. No one remains banned for more than like 10 minutes and that's when we forget.
It's just for the purposes of memes. That's not a good position for Rim, but it doesn't matter. Okay, and there is a good amount of stability here, so all the control effects don't do shit for Axel, and he wasted Moa as well. This is not looking good for Axel right now. Although surely this can't be Resident Sleeper.
Surely not, that would be ridiculous.
The thing is that the Mesmer's actual damage reduction is not at all affected by going YOLO. They still have all these blocks, the distortion, the teleports, just having loads of copies of yourself, you know, it doesn't really make any difference. From the perspective of the Mesmer. There's Confuse Beam, confusing images.
Ooh, that is looking
That's
nasty.
That's 10 stacks! But does manage to get it cleansed off, however... Celestial Avatar is completely uncharged right now, so he's going to need to get that back. Look how fast it charges with all the memes he's got.
Yeah.
Oh my god, look at that. So this is why Druid is just so dirty.
Now he's got it again.
He's got it again. This is so disgusting. Yeah.
Yeah, he's growing big. There's he's got the stability avatar again. Heating up. Oh no.
Yeah. Wait, does he have Dwayne or something? No, he is Melandry. But the thing is, he's got natural healing, okay? He's got Troll Engine, basically permanent regen. So his avatar, look how fast it goes up. Look at this shit!
It's just straight back to full again.
Look at that!
It barely has time to go on cooldown.
ArenaNet, what is this profession? Seriously.
Oh my god.
So funny. And Axelwear has a lot of damage, but all the condies are just worthless against the druid. And, oh, you know, maybe you can kill it. Maybe you can kill. Maybe? Cyan is giving Axel his energy. And the double block wombo combo. It's an immobilize. He's got three illusions. Ripe for the shattering. Well, they don't blew themselves up now.
Okay. Oh, maybe.
Oh, dear.
For Axel.
Axel's in a little bit of trouble here. Gets dazed as well, and he's got no dodge roll.
Yeah.
Manages to get away.
Walk away, yeah.
He is just struggling to be able to even kill Rim here.
Neither of them kill each other. It's a disaster.
Yeah. That, unfortunately, this will have to... we will have to institute the no running away rule if none of them are able to land a killing blow here.
Yeah.
Which will basically give Rim a free win.
Yeah.
But maybe he won't even need that because Axel is currently in the process of slowly dying. Although he's managed to get the MOA, though. This could be huge. And he got the continuum split as well.
Oh, that's
not
good.
Not the MOA kill. The ultimate humiliation. Okay, is he going to go for a second MOA? Oh, no, the stability, though. Oh, no.
Oh.
Axel is all out of health right now.
And he might
I think he's going to go down here. It's 76 health and he's down. Rim.
After a long and grueling series, claims it.
Oh my god. Ugh. Rim manages to take it after a very long series. Ugh. That took a while, didn't it? Easy win. The Bears win again, right? So the Bear is new meta. Why doesn't he double MOA? I don't know. Maybe he could have won if he double MOA'd. I don't know. Maybe he didn't think he had line of sight. But now we're going to go ahead and move on to Inny versus Plenix. And that is going to be coming up right now. I'll actually just check if Nasir is online. Ah, Nasir is online. So actually, you know what? Screw this match. We're going to do Nasir versus Ziggy. Ziggy has been waiting for a very long time. Nasir, another Mesmer. And now this, arguably, could be a better build. Oh, shit, look at this build. Oh my god. Okay, so, look at all these awesome traits. Master Fragmentation, Maim the Disillusioned, Illusionary Reversion, Chrono Phantasma, Persisting Images, Restorative Illusions, Illusionary Restoration, that actually doesn't do anything. But, all in all, some strong memes.
That is nasty.
So, yeah. But Ziggy, look at this scrapper build. Just look at this scrapper build, okay? We have got ourselves a hammer with a healing turret, bulwark gyro. If he had elixir gun, that's actually meta. But he has elixir C, which could honestly be better, you know? What?
Yeah.
Why the Dan's game got the free win? What? What are you even talking about? I don't understand. The Dan's game didn't get the free win. Yeah, a very strong build for Ziggy here. Tools, Alchemy, Scrapper. HGH, he does own Elixir, so that's a bit better. Self-regulating defenses, nice trait. Become Tiny. Oh, Applied Force, Rapid Regeneration, Recovery Matrix. The traits are a little bit not quite there for Ziggy here.
Yeah, the Gyro as well.
The Gyro is good. 50% damage. Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, I guess it's pretty good. I want the blast one, to be honest. The blast one was so sick last time.
Mm.
It just works, you know.
Oh, yeah, that's true, actually. I fell in. That's the free win instead of random user. Never mind. But here is Nasir. Cyhan is role-playing as Ziggy.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, makes perfect sense. Anyway. You know, the traits could be better for Ziggy, but his utilities and weapon are very, very good. So, I think we can get into this. This is Evict Cyhan. Ziggy's definitely here. Yeah, he is. Bleep. Role-playing as a V-bot.
Mr. Destructoid.
So, here we go. Ziggy, Priap, Marauder. Yeah. Marauder, Holbrack. It's a solid choice. And then Generosity, Hydromancy. He has got himself as... Well, he actually got this drop on Monday. The Sloth Hammer.
Oh, and someone's asking, can we explain rules for builds? You can go over them because you made it, you know, better.
Okay, so, if you are familiar with Hearthstone, you know it exactly what's happening here. So, you'll be offered three professions. You can pick one of those. Then you get to pick one of three trait lines. You pick one. One of three again, because obviously you have to pick three. Then one of three again. Then you pick the traits. Three, 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 three. Then you pick, what comes after that? Then you pick a heal, then your utilities and your elite skill, then you pick your weapons, and you pick a pet.
To clarify, with the way that the traits work, you don't just pick it out of three traits, otherwise you literally just pick your tree. It gets three traits from different trees, and you have to choose one.
Yes, exactly. Just like a children's card game.
Yeah, if you play Hearthstone, then it's basically like Arena, but with builds. Normally they're completely random, but this is the finals. So they're not. Yeah.
So, here we go. Oh! The Reflect. Oh, this is hilarious, because if you reflect the clone, it spawns a clone that attacks you.
Oh, wow.
That's pretty funny. Sick. Oh, all these reflects from Ziggy, though. These memes. Yeah. Why isn't he attacking?
This doesn't feel like it.
He's a scrapper. He can just kill. That's exactly what he's going to try and do. I mean, he's on low health. Oh, no!
Wait, Ziggy's
healing turret got interrupted!
Yeah, interrupted, he's small, but he's got a healing turret.
What a disaster! Yeah, he's going to just pop that healing turret. There we go.
Explode, of course.
But does it even matter? The medkits are down as well. He's going to start attacking the seer, but it turns out shield is pretty good.
Yeah.
And the confusion never ends here for Ziggy. He is having a little bit of trouble here. And oh, the shield! Oh, okay, instability, never mind. I would have been huge, but then again, it was tiny because of the reflects and everything. Another healing turret. The forehead spam begins by Ziggy. The memes. Moa is still available, though. He might. Is he going to use it to finish off or just to deny some CC? Oh, the duelist, the real MVP.
Oh, and the duelist. It's going to do it.
Yeah, gives Nasir the opportunity to go for the kill. Oh shit! This is the wrong overlay. Hang on. I didn't select the game. Never mind. There we go. Whoops, that was a misclick. And Nasir is going to take the first game here. There you go. So there you have it. I'll just clarify, Sotaporsis, that this is the grand final. So this is the only time where those builds are drafted. Normally, they're just totally random for one profession.
It is a clown fiesta.
Yeah. It is a massive clown fiesta. Because we're on the wrong interface, go ahead and bet right now who you think's going to win. Yeah. Da-da-da. Sears guy is ready to go. Random gets fixed score. His rig builds. So. What will Ziggy do? Keeps thinking he has Elixir Gun. That is not the case. Elixir C is a bit like Elixir Gun because it is an Elixir.
Yeah, not quite the same.
But it's not quite the same.
Act like commit Sudoku.
Yeah, oh no.
Not a massive surprise.
Well, he keeps his honor though. Keeps his honor.
He's retained.
Look at all this, these memes, these fresh memes this guy has. Confusion you inflict lasts longer. Confusion is this cancer. This dirty, dirty ability. Look at this confusion. Cry of frustrations. Think how much confusion that is. It's a lot.
Very, very confusing.
Yeah, Z just doesn't know what to do. That's why he thought that Elixir C was Elixir Gun. He got confused.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, it's confusion.
Okay, here we go. Ziggy, will he be able to make a better try of it this time? Gets the Thunderclap. Is he going to rocket charge through it? Nope. Doesn't feel the need to do so. The Bulwark Gyro is up. That will give him some damage reduction, but the damage reduction doesn't help you against all that confusion. And then the stun from the shield as well. This is absolutely disastrous for Ziggy. He calls down some... Oh no! Is it only Elixir C cancels the supply crate?
Oh, he just got kind of trolled there by Elixir C.
But... It's okay. Oh, wait, he's dead. Yep, he's dead. Wait, use Elixir C.
He got trolled by Elixir S. Why didn't he use Elixir C? He can just cleanse all that shit off. He can convert them all into boons as well. Yeah. Oh well, he's dead now. Nasir wins 2-0.
Did you see that? Red team got a capture point.
Yeah.
God, the fractal reliquary is insane value.
What do you mean?
The thing that Simon was basically talking about.
Why is it insane value?
It's kind of like the currency converter thing, whatever it's called, the Leyenji matter converter or the karma converter. But it costs 25 fractal relics, and it can give you the fractal equipment boxes.
Holy shit, that's actually pretty good value.
And ascended salvage tools and ascended salvage kits even. Oh my god, this thing is crazy if you get lucky.
So that's actually all the round of 8 round of 16 is done now. But there've been 2 Gans games. Oh no. It's quite unfortunate, but what should we move on to now? Who has been waiting? Oh, we'll do Innie versus Plenix, seeing as that's kind of the next one in. So here we go, Scrapper versus Reaper. Now, I would say this probably favours the Reaper here because of all the boon strip. But maybe it won't.
It generally does favour Reapers and PP, so, you know, maybe.
Especially that Plenix is a very beefy Reaper build here with Death Magic. Yeah. Corruptus Fervor is going to get free toughness and so on. And with the minions with Rise as well. He's going to be pretty well off when it comes to physical damage.
That's nice for him. And then Innie did win pretty well that first time. He just kind of went in and won. And that was that.
Yeah.
However, so I guess we'll see. But then Giordano was too beefy to die.
But you do never underestimate the damage of a Marauder Scrapper. That hammer is very, very dangerous indeed. Very, very dangerous. Yes, place your bets now. Place your bets now.
So, yeah. It does have an Elixir gun here. So we'll be able to deal with conditions. Elixir U. Oh. We'll also get rid of a condition because of, alchemical tinctures. For that. But Plenix, he does. He won't really need the condition cleanse here. Stun breaks will be good to deal with the slick shoes. And in fact, he might be kind of fucked when it comes to slick shoes.
So, you reckon?
Yeah. Because what do you do?
That's true. That is also the case in the regular game, though.
Yes.
You're just fucked.
He doesn't have any. You can use the shout to get stability.
Yeah, it just destroys your stability, though.
Yeah.
What can you do?
Where Plenix, is he AFK? Press 3. He does have that, but if you get knocked down, that's pretty feels bad, man. But where is Plenix? He's gone AFK, it seems. Plenix, back to us. Okay, here he is.
There he is, small panel.
We're good to go. Is he running with the same setup? Almost certainly. He should probably change soldier here. That's not going to do much. Unless he just wants toughness and vitality. Yep, there we go. Nightmare, just as I thought.
Yeah.
And Svanir! Whoa! Is this a next level play?
Chill duration, frost aura.
So, 50% reduced chill duration. Holy shit!
That is very clever.
Adaptive armor. With the adaptive armor, 20% more. 70% reduced chill duration.
That is going to be nasty.
Innie! Oh my god. The IQ of this player is too high.
So the question is, if Ryze hits healing turret, will it spawn an extra dude?
Wow.
Or a supply crate turret for that matter. He could get a lot of
dudes. I think
it
does, yeah. He'll get mass dudes. Wow. This is new meta to counter Reapers. Toughness and negative chill duration. Wow. So smart. And you get Frost Aura as well, on a 90-second cooldown. Why does the fucking 6 suck so much? Why is it so bad? I don't understand. They make these runes deliberately useless, so no one will ever use them.
Yeah.
Yeah. What the hell?
There are some pretty bad
runes out there. And Purity as well. A sensible choice. Although, actually, there is literally no reason to not use generosity here. That's a weird choice, if you ask me. Maybe concerned about transferring it back? Maybe?
Well, yeah, he has 50% crit.
Hmm. Yeah.
I don't know, Kevin.
Yeah.
He's probably got his reasons, though.
This is good. If this wins, the new meta is so good. The chill is not going to last very long at all on any. This is pretty smart. How much IQ do you need to win the finals? I don't know. I don't know, Kevin. Probably
Kevin.
Quite a lot.
About 420, maybe?
420.
420 IQ.
420 IQ. Oh, wow. The smoke field leap for the stealth. It's not going to do anything, but it's still cute.
Yeah, it was cool. It looked cool.
Yeah.
And here he goes.
And here comes Innie, slowly marching into combat. Oh, doesn't she get stunned by that? But can she use a numerous stun breaks to try and do something?
There's the spike
leaps
right down.
In. Does a good amount of damage. Oh, that Electro Whirl really hurts. Fumigates all over Planix for a bit of poison, although maybe not the best choice because he probably has some... He has Suffer to transfer back. That will only transfer one of them, I suppose. Corrupt Boon could be pretty good here. We'll get rid of Fury, Swiftness, and one stack of Might. Oh, no! Oh,
the intro.
Yeah, you want to try and avoid getting hit by those powerful Reaper attacks, both the Chill Shout and the Shroud 5. Don't want to get hit by those. Healing Turret's back, though. Here we go.
Yeah,
he was poisoned, though, while that happened, which is a little bit unfortunate.
It wasn't quite as effective. Planix still has consumed conditions, which is quite nice.
Yeah, he does have the heal. I mean, it's actually pretty bad, because there aren't going to be that many conditions on him. Only the vulnerability. But there's the Slick Shoes. He tries to go for the stability.
Annoying.
Can he get it, though? The problem is here for Planix. If he loses this first game, he will probably not... Well, tilt really badly. And lose the other game.
Oh, it doesn't look too good for
but
him either.
It's not looking great for him right now. Can he survive until he can get some Shroud Juice? It doesn't look like he can, and he is going to go down here. And Innie, the new meta versus Reaper with the chill duration reduction takes
clever.
The first game there. Rip Planix. Oh, it's not over yet. It's only one game.
It's not over yet. It's never over.
Lowest IQ wins. Well, let's see what happens next. Will Planix return?
He doesn't have Sorrow up and Chill Duration wouldn't matter.
Honestly, I think the Chill Duration's really smart. I really like this. This is my favorite part of Mystic Builds.
Very, very clever.
And I like this a lot. Well done, Innie. Even if you lose, you get the award for creativity.
Clever award.
With the TLO award. You're the TLO of Guild Wars 2.
TLO, yeah. Innovative player. Very creative.
Yeah. So creative. Yeah. There goes the only way Rim doesn't win Bracket A. Not like this. Oh, wait. Is he coming back? He must be. He's probably changing his rune. He is still here.
Yeah.
Reaper Shroud plus. Yeah. He wants the anti-chill. The anti-chill! Whoa.
Yeah.
Melandry, I mean, yeah, maybe Melandry would be better overall, but look at this, the minus 70% duration on Chill with the Svarne range. You've got to go all in. So good. Oh, interesting now. Going for Wanderers. So going for Duration.
Okay.
So, now
so he's countering.
Yeah, he's countered it. He's countered the rune. He has 57% duration now.
Yeah, that's genius.
Wow. An undead, so extra toughness, which is going to synergize with that Wanderer. So he's got very high condition damage right now, 1.6k. And of course, the lower health pool doesn't really affect him against power damage. So that's a really great choice there by Planix. But can he make it work? Look how long these bleeds last now. It's pretty good. He does use, the Purity procs there. Does get rid of it, though. Planix is doing very, very well here right now, kiting Innie around all over the place. And those 9 stacks of bleeding. Ouch. Yeah, the Reaper is really bringing their pain right now. Cancels his shout there. I think it was a little bit by accident, a little bit on purpose. But there goes the Elixir.
Killing little fuckers, so no more little fuckers anymore.
Yeah.
Planix is doing pretty decently here. Does want to get out of that field. Oh, but he doesn't really have any shroud energy. I mean, the only way you can really get it is with the dagger chain. I mean, he has the Reaper's Touch. That produces a good amount of it. But other than that, all he has is Feast of Corruption and a Locust Swarm. Yeah. So he doesn't have a particularly reliable way of getting it. And see, he barely has any energy. Although, he might just drop a kill here.
He's got Condies on him.
Yeah, if he can get a few more auto attacks, maybe yeah, and Plenix. He's making the comeback. That's exactly what's happened here. Yep, he's won this. Okay, there's 100% chance. It's pretty much impossible. But I'm so tiny. Yes, Win Rim SM Walk. So Plenix evens it up. 1-1 here. He's not gonna go down without a fight with his giant Norn.
His face looks kinda like John Cena, but then again, John Cena is the most generic face ever.
Yeah. Actually does look quite a lot like John Cena.
Yeah.
not really, but
you know. I don't know. I'm seeing it, to be honest. He's got like that. Yeah, that little stocky chin, and it's definitely John Cena.
Check the mod war, you piece of shit. Plenix is angry. I like Plenix when he's trying, because when he's trying, he gets fucking angry. It's hilarious. Good. So good.
Rex bet against not make the
same
mistake.
Oh, shit.
Oh!
Here we go. No. Considering his next move?
Yeah.
Presumably? Maybe he's going to pick a different rune. Or a different amulet. I don't know. It could be anything. It could be so many things.
It could be.
Yeah. No, Kevin.
I don't know, Kevin. People tried to rig the system. Yeah, it's rigged.
You should be getting new clovers now. The API is semi-working. Yep, should be working. Should be getting a good amount of memes. Probably, maybe. I don't know. Oh, wow. Look, he's exploited.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Oh, wow.
Oh.
Oh, my God.
How did he even get here?
What the hell? Okay, this is Paul's tournament. This is pretty interesting. Well, he's now going to get banned by Arena, being out of bounds.
Pretty good, actually.
Yeah, I vote for Rex, I vote for Trump, there you go. If you want Trump in, just vote for Rex.
What if Salt Guild members are actually the top Guild Wars 2 players that are just role-playing as clowns? Okay, so wait, can you...
Whoa! That is trippy!
Yeah, what the hell is going on?
What do you mean, what if? They are! What the hell?
What the fuck is this?
Is he just going to emerge underneath?
How is he doing that? And he can he doesn't have any underwater skills. Where can he? What is this shit?
What is this?
Oh! What the hell?
Oh my god, exploiter.
It looks like floating islands now. Looks pretty cool, actually.
It's kind of cool, actually. It's like Edge of the Mist, except Edge of the Mist. Where's he going to go to? Let's see. We're now in exploits. Yeah, Plenix is Zach. There you go.
Yeah, he's Zach's new account, Plenix. Wow, that is bizarre. Oh.
Oh, he's reached the edge of the map. Oh, he's... Everything's starting to go wrong now.
That's
quite random. Oh, the match starts soon. All right, let's go.
Can you go Lord like this? How did he do that?
I don't even know.
How did he do that? I'm gonna watch the VOD now.
Yeah, and he's back now.
Yeah. He's beyond, obviously.
If you could escape there during the actual match, that could be very, very abusable.
Yeah.
Probably wouldn't be, but it might be.
You have to spawn on the outside of the little gate cage thing. It's a glitch. Makes sense. Okay. Let's see if Planix can seal the deal. Or will Innie has gone tryhard, going for Melandru now. So the chill will last longer, but all the, everything else will last not as long. And actually, Innie has got off to a great start here. Oh, did his heal just get cancelled?
It did.
Oh, no.
Oh, that's not good for
great
him.
Great kind of either god-tier timing by Innie or just pure RNG. But I think Plenix is dead.
The heal, but he's...
He's got the chill shout. Can he corrupt some of those boons? That would be really nice. He does succeed in doing that. Can he get enough life force to get a shroud up again, though? He's got a dodge, but he goes into shroud with no real juice.
Yeah, he's just got now he's out of health, and that might just be it.
Yeah, it is it. Oh, no. Wow, he was typing. Why were you typing? And Innie. Oh, no. The BM smiley face.
Oh, savage.
That's honestly one of the most disrespectful things you can say after winning. Now, yep. Innie takes it 2-1. Just came out of nowhere on that game, just like John Cena.
Yeah, his time. Their time was up and his time was now.
Yeah. Wow. There you go. Enjoy the bets. Nah, that smiley face. Yeah, that is brutal, isn't it?
That is.
My God. That's so harsh. Okay, now we're going to move on to... Oh, Random User's first game. Oh, no. This is actually so bad for him. He's going to lose.
You reckon?
Yeah, he's dead. I don't know. Unless he is literally God, I don't think he can win this.
Oh, maybe he can't. Yeah.
Because he...
So he's got his classic threat. Oh, but he's against this cancer-ass chrono build. Oh, no. Muser is dead? Yeah, maybe. Random Muser. Oh, hold on. Yeah, T-Bot's mic is definitely gone. I thought that he just wasn't speaking, but... Cannot hear him.
Am I broken?
Yeah. I thought that you were just like doing something, so I was like, oh, what?
Wait, can you hear me?
Yes, I can now.
Is it okay? You should be able to hear me. Oh, wow, weird bug. OBS has bugged out. Never mind. Oh. I'm back. Let's see.
The planning's gone.
Random. He does have a lot of condition cards, because think about this. He's got himself. Ether Renewal, which could be really good here. But then again, against a Chrono with mass interrupts, is it really good? I don't know. It could be a problem. I mean, he does have a lot of... He's got Final Shielding, Evasive Arcana, Arcane Shield and Mistform. He's got a lot of mitigation here. But I don't know.
I'm not looking so good for Random, I have to say. His build is good, but... That Chronomancer build is very good.
Yeah, it is very good. And Random doesn't even have Tempest. But he does have Fresh Air and Scepter, which is exactly what you want. Lots of immunities for him. But can he get the kill?
I don't know, Kevin.
Okay. Saihan again is role-playing. Role-playing as Random User.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah. Is it where is Nasir gone? Nasir is gone, by the way.
Oh no! What?
That is unusual. But yeah. Oh well. Let's have a look at some of these traits Random has. Well, he's got Soothing Disruption. He does have a cantrip, two cantrips actually, and he has his traited heal, really short cooldown on it. I think it's about 14 and 3/4 seconds or something. And that will cleanse 8 conditions. So if he can manage to get a few of those off, he'll be in good shape. Especially if he can combo with Arcane Shield. Or Obsidian Flesh. Because, of course, he's got the focus. Invasive Arcana is obviously very good. Arcane Abatement is not very good. It's kind of interesting. Oh, I see. I think I know why you pick a crappy falling damage trait. Because you're trying to fish for a good trait that isn't that isn't an adept trait, yeah?
That's kind of clever, actually.
So you want to get... For example, maybe he got offered
two Grandmaster traits that he didn't want in Arcane, so he picked the Falling Damage trait to give him another shot at Evasive Arcane. In fact, he definitely did. But... Oh, wait. Ziggy is now here as well. And... This is now a roleplay match at this point. And Saihan is gone. Saihan is still there. But I think we can kind of get into this. Yeah. Okay, I can't say I'm saying this, but go random. Hello, people. I will give this place to Muser when he stickies the next Mystic Pills Reddit post. Type /Y to accept the condition. But you can't type /Y. Because it would say command unknown. He's role-playing as a bot, though. Because he is kind of a bot setup, as you can tell, because he's a robot.
Yeah, obviously.
Slick shoes is the most annoying thing in this current meta. Nah, there's way more annoying shit than fucking slick shoes.
Oh, no, slick shoes is just... Oh.
I think the most frustrating thing is probably Surge and Rescue. It's a stupid
ability. Oh my god, yeah, it's so annoying.
Yeah.
Because you can't even stop them arriving once they've done that.
Hey, what the hell is this offhand he's got? Hell. Bloodseeker. Huh. Not like this. Yeah. Dan's game. Okay. Who will even win here? Will anyone win? I think Ziggy's just auto-attacking. He's still winning.
Yeah, maybe.
The Spear of Justice. Yeah, Ziggy's just auto-attacking. Oh, wait, he's lagging. Okay. Resident Sleeper! Okay, he's gone. Will this force Saihan to leave? Maybe? Oh my god. This is looking grim for Mystic Builds, bleep bloop. Don't you feel have to sleep? No, only memes. Oh shit. If Saihan doesn't leave, he'll ban mysticbuilds.com from r/guildwars2. That is a disaster. Okay. Random is in. Marauder Eagle. Classic combo. Absolutely. Gonna get some dirty lightning strike and air achievement crits.
Marauder Eagle, this is like the random user classic here. They're in the same place.
This is the wrong number. This is Bladicus.
No, what's he doing in here?
This is the wrong number. What's he even here for? Oh my god. Yeah. We should ban Muser too. Wow, this match has turned into a clown fiesta.
Yeah, this entire time.
Hang on. He's in the fucking wrong keep as well.
Yeah, exactly.
What is even going on here? Okay, just here, quick, get in. As you can see, random user, he's got himself the wings. Yeah. Where is Nasir though? Yeah, here he is. Wait, what? Oh my god, random is trolling me really hard. He just leaves now. Come back. Yeah. Okay, now he's in the correct zone. Go! Ban or Rito. Bring back the bear. The bear will be back, don't worry, Bioballs.
Yeah, if you guys are bored, you can unleash the bears in chat, to be honest. You know. Oh, never mind, no, don't unleash the bears, the fight is starting. Okay, keep the bears at minimum.
So, I mean, Soothing Disruption is really good here, and so is Soothing Ice, because he has Cleansing Water, okay? So whenever he attunes to water, he cleanses a Condi, because he gains regen because of Arcane. And whenever he uses Misform, he cleanses a condition.
Yeah.
Whenever he uses Aether Renewal, he cleanses 9 conditions. This is some pretty good shit. Whenever he uses Scepter Water 3, cleanses a condition. These are all nice memes.
Yeah, they're pretty nice. Let's get a little Condis here. But, he's against a Mesmer, and Mesmers are quite annoying.
Yes. Gonna take focus, some god tier focus fire here for him to actually get this. I mean, he can use Earth all he wants, but will that actually do? Wait, the fresh air pain train is about to begin.
Oh, he lands
a phoenix, but he doesn't manage to, you know, sometimes you can really abuse the train and get about 3 hits. Doesn't manage to get that off this time. And random user, gonna use Aether Renewal, heals him to full. Honestly, every time he uses that, it's pretty much a full heal. At 14 and a half seconds. Some good shit. Again, he just goes back to air. Gonna go for maybe... Oh, nope, that phoenix doesn't do anything. Another condition cleanse on that phoenix. Yeah. And
that's a confusion beam. It doesn't really do much. It just cleanses off.
Yeah, I mean, it's gonna be pretty easy for Random to deal with a lot of this stuff. However, it's not gonna be easy to do when he's stunned. And look how long this channel is, because he was slowed for a part of it.
Mm.
But he does have a lot of healing. Of course, he is an elementalist, so that does happen. Nasir is getting lowered here. Gets hit by a massive stun there, though. I think that was the magic bullet. Yep. And there's a lot of illusions. An Aether Feast. Big heal with the triple illusion. Random does seem to be struggling a little bit here. This needs to get enough burst to get the work done.
Random isn't dying. He's very good.
He isn't dying. Oh, but here's the combo. Oh, he didn't manage to get the Dragon Sooth off. But wait, the 8 stacks of confusion, the counter of fresh air.
Yeah.
Especially Elementalist, because attuning actually causes you to take damage from the confusion.
I can confirm that Modramoth's message there is true. Not getting banned by modern arenas is the hard bit. Anyway, they're still fighting. There's another Phantasmal Defender to be annoying and take this
damage. Nice. Dodges there. Manages to dodge the Phoenix completely and heal back up. But how long will this last?
I don't know, Kevin.
I don't know, Kevin. And here comes Random. He's sheathing and unsheathing constantly.
Classic Random user.
What's he even? Oh, wait. He's not interested in chasing. Is coming back. Goes for the block. Flies the Torment, but that's cleansed off by the Magnetic Wave of Random. Phoenix gets a fairly big hit. The Swirling Winds is actually really good, because it blocks all the Scepter projectiles. It's a lot of damage coming out from Random user. That fresh air is pretty damn powerful. Goes back to air for more damage. Distortion, though, saves him, but another Lightning 2. Could have done something there. All that confusion, that's irrelevant thanks to that Aether Renewal. He gets a massive Phoenix, but actually no, it looked way massiver.
It looked a lot larger than it was.
It looked ridiculous, but actually it was only just really good. Still, Nasir is taking quite a lot of damage here.
He's
Random, does he smell blood? If he gets
the
Dragon Suit,
obviously misses that, but it's never hit. It's gonna get 20 minutes.
You can't hit that shit. No. Oh, but there's, okay, he's a mower. This is gonna give Nasir some breathing room here.
Yeah.
Oh, if he just disengages, that's Dan's game. But actually, he needed to be the aggressive mower there, actually, because now this is going to go to Resident Sleeper. But actually, this is terrible for Nasir, because he has to go to one defensive meme.
Oh yeah, he's losing a lot from this. It's random. He's losing a little bit. But he loses nothing, it's still Marauder.
Exactly, he loses nothing. This is disastrous for Nasir, actually. He needed to... Oh, wait, actually, he might just die anyway. Never mind. In fact, it would actually be better for him to lose now, I think. I think if he's tactical, he should lose. And then he can...
Seriously think?
Yeah, because he can keep his amulet. Otherwise, he has to get rid of Mercenary.
Oh, my God. Imagine if he did that. How cool would that be?
If he's that meta that he actually knows to throw right now, that'll be pretty sick. Oh yeah, Signet of Earth, great thing to have for random. That long immobilized, 3 second immobilized. He's a mower!
That's 5 seconds left. Yeah, just like that, Blue Team got a capture point.
Yeah.
I love the announcer in Guild Wars, he's great.
And that's it. Resident Sleeper. Even bothering casting Dragon's Tear. I mean, maybe if you can immobilize with Signet of Earth, maybe you can hit it. You know? But other than that, it's not very likely to land, is it?
No. What is the delay on Dragon's Tooth, by the way? It seems like it's about 10 minutes.
It's a very long time. I don't know the exact time.
I don't feel like it's, you know, if I know it's not designed PvP, it's designed PvE.
It takes ages.
You don't,
it's
you
high
don't...
risk, high reward, yeah?
It's not even high risk. You just put it down. It's like, well, that missed.
Well, I mean, it's useless, but if it lands, yeah. There's a lot of damage. Uh-oh. Yeah. Or actually, we should make this more fair.
Yeah.
If we say one defensive, you might as well just say Nasir loses.
Yeah.
We have to make it as fair as possible, and I think that just say no running is better.
All right, no running then. So they have to stay. They have to stay within the wall part of the middle area, right?
Yeah.
Can they go on the second level? Is it like a mini courtyard? They can't, can they? It's pretty much just on the point a little bit around it.
Yeah. I don't think that really disadvantages random user as well. He's got a good amount of sustain. Yeah. Well, yeah, what does the V face even mean?
I don't even know. We're about to find out. I don't know. Okay, I'll look it up. I'll look it up. V face.
Yeah.
Nobody knows.
I think the honestly, it not being able to run away might be actually really bad for Nasir as well. Honestly, they call me the cringe lord on Helsa's chat. Oh, well, that's because I am. You don't see all these cringe fists I'm giving out, man. Hold on to your points. Seize
theirs. Shit, you're fucking famous, Teapot.
Yeah, well, I mean, it could be worse. I mean, I could be a role player. I mean, Helseth is a pretty damn big role player. So
that's true.
I mean, yeah. So it could be a lot worse. Is the edgy smiley? Edgy smiley.
Edgy smiley. Okay.
Yeah, so here we go. It begins. The amount of blocks will be very handy, but wait, is Nasir just dead? What?
What is this?
What's going on?
Random user. No random user. Fucks.
How is he doing this? This is such a bad matchup for him, but it doesn't matter, apparently. Because he is pretty far ahead here right now. He doesn't have any heals, though. But wait. What?
What is this?
Why didn't he just do this first?
Yeah, what? Nothing's different. He just couldn't run as much.
It's the same. It's just the same, God. And he won in about 30 seconds.
What is this? Fucking clown fiesta.
What is this? And random is gonna win. How did he win? That's such a bad matchup for him. That's so bad for him. And he still won anyway. Wow.
Wow, that just happened.
Yeah, that just happened. It, all for the roleplay.
All for the roleplay.
I did not see that one coming. I was really careful about doing that, but apparently random user doesn't care.
Yeah, he just wins.
I mean, that was definitely the worst draw compromise for him as well. I mean, switching to Carrion would have been a free win for him, but apparently he just wins anyway.
Yeah, he just kind of does it.
Yeah. Yeah. That was a pretty big troll. Well, let's find out what's going to happen next. Because, wait, is that all the round of 8 dinosaur? It is. Yeah. So, let's see what is next. It's Inny versus Rim. That's what it is. So, Grappa versus Druid. This could be Resident Sleeper. This is going to be a slow one. Both very sustaining. Healing turret.
Well, then again, actually, it's Rim. I was going to say if the druids so far haven't been too bad, apart from Rim. And what do you know? It's Rim.
The druid. And I mean, troll engine, celestial avatar, staff, mass stability, mass memes, healing turret. This could take a while. This could take a little while for sure. Where is Rim? Okay, here he is. Alright, well, we might as well just go going. We've already seen these builds. We know what's up.
Oh, they're in the same place. The bear is going crazy.
The bear is back! Such damage, much pain, very hurt. Innie embracing the memes. Going for Rin of the Scrapper. Gonna try and stay in close proximity of Rim. To avoid dying. What's actually radius on that? 600? It's a pretty big radius. Rim is going for Paladin here. And also Scrapper. So when they don't actually have any runes. The runes cancel out. Ah, yeah. This is going to be Resident Sleeper here, I think. Let's see how this goes, shall we?
Yep.
Here we go.
The Town Fiesta is about to begin.
It is. I think there's a lot of the Scrapper irritation. I think Slick Shoes almost does nothing here, because of all the stability that just pulses all the time.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, just look at this. Strength of the pack is 48 second cooldown because it's traded.
Yeah, and the stability is.
Well, it's gone now.
It's gone now,
so,
yeah.
So, I mean, he might be able to get some work done. But, I mean, even with Marauder versus Paladin, I'm not sure if Innie can really get a lot done here. Although, then again, he is right now. And there's another turret, detonated for mass healing. But, I mean, look at the healing that Rim is just putting out. It's ridiculous.
It is. He just doesn't die.
He doesn't die, but will Innie either, you know?
I don't know. Rim, he hasn't got as much sustain as the issue. I mean, he's got the healing turret, but Rim isn't going to be able to burst.
Oh, wow. Rim is just... He's going for the kill right now.
He is, but he's not going to get it because his healing turret detonation.
Yeah, healing turret's up, but then it's down for a pretty decent amount of time, really. And Rim does have solid damage as well. Maybe if you could poison Innie... To deny a lot of the healing turret healing, it might work out well. Honestly, I'm not sure if this ends.
I don't know.
Yeah. Do we even need to commentate? Will this end? If Rim had damaging pets, he'd probably be in a great spot.
Yeah, it would, but... He doesn't, he's got the fucking bear.
I think I might change it so you can pick 6 pets. How about that?
Yeah, that's a good idea, actually.
So suppose that you get for pets because there's a lot more pets. What if you get to choose between 6 pets instead of 3 pets?
Yeah, you gotta have something to limit though because there's a lot of pets, but a lot of them are garbage.
Maybe if I...
But if the choice is too wide, everyone's just gonna pick Smoke Scale Bristleback.
Exactly, because that's what you want.
Yeah.
Because Power Creep, Ellie Giggle.
Yeah.
Another healing turret. Oh, wait. Oh, no, never mind. I almost thought that got interrupted there. That would have been massive. Rim was waiting for it, but he didn't quite get it.
He might just get it now, though, because healing turret's down for, like, years.
Yeah.
Dude's got 7 seconds of healing turret, but it's not going
to
come.
Oh, Rim manages to take it. Yeah. Ouch. Huh. And it looks like Rim takes that first game, but it was pretty close. It was so ridiculous. Ban Druid. Maybe Druid does have to be banned. It is just ridiculous.
Yeah, it's just stupid. I think it's the way you play it. I mean, I don't mean to diss Rim here, but the other Druids have had quite aggressive builds, and Rim has just gone like, I'm going to win this.
No, the thing is, Rim is very experienced a Druid. He knows what traits to look out for, you know?
That's true, actually, yeah.
He's picked the things that just charges Avatar ridiculously fast, you know? Yeah. I mean, you can see, you can just watch it, and it's just, it goes so fast, you know?
Yeah.
It's just, and if you take away Druid, I mean, Ranger is going to be pretty lackluster.
It's going to be pretty bad, yeah.
And then no one picks Ranger. You know? It's injured. Yeah, it's difficult to balance. We're now in Anet's shoes, except we can't change the numbers.
I don't know. I feel like, yeah. Yeah. If we should, they should give us balancing rights so we can just change it. That's what I'm saying.
I mean, the key here is that Rim, he got the shout trait, is a really big deal. I mean, Guard is pretty solid as well. And obviously, strength of the pack. I mean, look at the regen. The regen, the natural healing, the troll ungent. Just everything he has, just, it makes him overpowered. Honestly. Oh! Here we go! It's YOLO! Full YOLO! Air Fire!
Oh,
Berserker,
wow.
Eagle! Last ditch effort from Innie to instantly kill Rem. Will it work? Yeah. Here we go. And the Kite Fiesta, that is the pain train. However, you know, being a scrapper, even if you're Zerker, you still have a decent amount of not dyingness. Such is the life of an NG. Well, where is Innie trying to lure his opponent? Maybe an open space like this, perhaps.
Yeah, here's the bashing, but the Drake's kind of just sitting there getting in the way. No poison field.
And just to get the intro, Electro Whirl unfortunately misses. Ah, oh, nice Signet of Stone.
Yeah.
From Rim, very smart. Just, he knows what's up. Rim knows exactly what Innie's trying to do here. Not falling for it at all. However, that Signet's down now. But Innie might have a shot here. To see. Using the Elixir Gun to execute the classic combo. Oh, Electro Whirl doesn't do anything again.
Yeah, but neither does Black Hole.
Yeah, honestly, getting hit by the Black Hole would be a death sentence at this point.
Yeah, it's such a long snare. It hits.
Oh, Innie is tiny.
He's tiny, yeah.
Can he get the healing turret? Yes. And goes for a leap as well. However, Innie is not getting a lot of work done here, honestly. Gonna try and pick up some of those medkits. There we go. Look at that. Just beautiful.
He's back.
There's the slick shoes. So Rim's a bit trapped there. This could be good. Not sure if it's good enough, though. Make StarCraft great again. Play Terran. Excellent. Excellent idea. This is... Oh, Rim is getting a little bit low here. Doesn't need to be careful. But I think he smells blood and he's going to go for it. And I think he will secure the kill here. And he will.
Yeah, he's done it. The Rim's Cancer Druid is through again.
Rest in pepperoni. Rim takes a 2-0 there. Hope you have fun with your fucking cancer. Innie not very happy with that, it would seem. Now we will move on to Rednaxla versus Random User. Reaper versus Elementalist. Fresh Air Elementalist.
Fresh Air, here it is.
Yeah.
So.
Here it is.
Yeah, it's going to be exciting.
It's going to be very exciting. Now, the corruption will be pretty solid. I mean, there'll be regen and vigor on random. So that's handy. But, can Rednaxla survive? I mean, consume conditions is not a great heal. Like, to
not
going to
work
us.
With this, no.
No. It's going to be a case of whether Rednaxla is capable of landing. If random can't dodge the shout and the Shroud 5 and so on. That's what's going to be the key here. And actually, the unblockable is going to be good against the Arcane Shield, seeing as it will negate it, shut it down. The bets are coming in now. Interesting.
Yeah, there's people think they know who's going to win.
Yeah. Yeah, Ichimon always gives his clovers away.
Why?
Yeah.
Well, he has no clovers now.
Oh, and the Protoss tears. I don't really have a lot of trouble with Protoss right now, Bolzano. It's kind of...
God, Bolzano, he is a long-time pleb. He's been around it for ages.
Yeah. Oh, wait, where did Random go? He's gone. Oh. He was there, and now he's not. Oh, well. Alright, here he's back. So, same setup. Leeching and air. Solid choice. Going to sustain him. I am better than that mighty teapot. Mate, we've already settled that one.
Oh.
You know what happened, M9. But, yeah. Well, that's really disturbing. You can see the eye. If you go into the head, you can see the eyes. That is very disturbing indeed.
That is disturbing.
These people are both legends, as you can tell. Random is an exalted legend. Red Naxxler is a primordial legend. So well, let's find out which title is better.
Exalted or primordial?
Exalted or primordial?
We need a 1v1 now, Baldana versus Teapot. That actually already happened.
Yeah.
You must have been around when that happened, Rex.
You are reborn. I like it. Occupy Mystic Bills for the sticky. Hashtag make Reddit great again. Wait. Oh, shit! The Lord Rush?
What is this?
Wow. Ah, lure. Oh, it was all a bait. It's a master bait. Red Naxxler using the next level strat. Yeah, look, it's baiting in random. Here he comes.
And now, Red Naxxler's gas are closed on cooldown, but he's not too worried about that.
Oh, Evasive Arcana got wasted there.
Yeah.
Oh, the fresh air damage is insane. It's so much.
Condition's already consuming into Reaper. He's going in with Death Charge.
Oh, he's trying to, he doesn't want to waste too much of that Shroud energy. Well, not come on. What is even going on here? People don't want to fight.
What is this Clown Fiesta?
What is this? What? It's already been, the other gate now.
This isn't going to work twice Red in a row. Then again, you have to stop him, otherwise he might just go win.
Yeah.
The Lord Kill is a win in this, so.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is. It's got to count as a win.
Why does that count as a win? That's stupid.
Because it's really difficult to do without getting killed.
Well, not if you're Grim.
Okay, forever and apart from
maybe on Stronghold.
Forever and apart from Rim, it counts as a win.
Oh, gets immobilized there by the Signet of Earth. Very good for the fresh air memes. And Red Naxxler gets interrupted. And Random is putting out a lot of damage here. Can the Reaper deal with it? He just has so many immunities. He's got the block, he's got the Mistform, he's got the Obsidian Flesh and the Focus.
He's not taking any damage.
He's not taking any damage. The fresh air memes. This can't be happening.
It's working.
It is happening. Red Naxxler's in. Oh, wait. No, now. Now, kind of all the cooldowns have run out for Random User. He is very low right now, but he manages to survive long enough for the Aether Arena. He'll be getting some boons there as well, the regen and vigor. However, he cleanses the conditions. That was great reaction time there. If he hadn't done that, he would have died in just a few seconds, but he gets stunned and he falls.
That's going to be it. And Random User goes down.
Yeah.
His chat is a bowler. Probably.
Yeah. Rip. Random User is down by one game here. Bring down the scythe. Oh, shit.
Oh.
Last second stun before mine with a V face, his new favorite meme.
Oh, no.
He's going to need to win two games in a row now. Although, in fairness, he does say that he throws the first game for the sake of roleplay sometimes.
That's true, yeah.
You do have to bear that in mind.
He might just be role-playing, that's a good point.
Yeah. He attacked the gate for life force, a very sensible decision. He should have gone for the Lord Rush, Ellie Giggle.
Do it, someone do it. That's just for fun, if nothing else.
Rim will do it.
Yeah. You should definitely count as a win.
So, one of these two people will be going to the final to face Rim.
Yeah.
Who would it be better off being? I think, Reaper actually is better because of all the corruption.
Yeah, I guess so, but
he doesn't have much corruption.
But you don't really care about boons in your druid though, that much. I suppose he's gonna get
there's
quite
a lot. Stability. Stability
is gonna get again.
I think Rim might. I think he's in a great position to win here, honestly. His build is just very good.
Yeah, he's pretty strong.
Even if I win, I don't want to face a druid. Yeah, no one wants to play against Rim.
Exactly. No, the loser is the real winner here.
Yeah.
Modern Ross actually sounds like Tiny Little Adolf.
Tiny Adolf. Hey. Reaper can actually win him.
Random will never die. Heroes never die. He's role-playing Stein.
Oh, he's a role-player.
A role-player.
I guess we always knew that he's a role-player.
Yeah, everyone knows. It's no secret, is it?
No.
Hey. Can he make it work a bit better last time? Gets the gasp. That's just broken up. Oh, nice Phoenix. Got two hits there, I think. Very, very nice. And then the fresh air combo just begins again. He does what comes. Oh, no, he dodged. Yeah, he needed to break out of that immediately. That could have been absolutely disastrous. However, he's taken a nice health lead here. And does Renex have a heal? No. Wow.
Oh,
the fiery greatsword to catch up as well. This is really good.
This is crazy. Random is just going.
Did he
insane.
Actually just throw the first game for fun?
Surely
what
not.
What is this guy?
He's just going crazy. He's not even getting close to dying.
No, he's doing so well right now, and he can cleanse off some conditions of that regeneration. And a Phoenix here. Oh, nope. They kind of bugged out and didn't do anything. Right.
Oh,
no!
Oh,
yeah! nearly got
very,
hit.
Very, very close to Dragus. Actually
nearly the suicide there. But, and Random's going to take a game here. Barely going below about 70% health.
The more important, the Dragon's Tooth nearly hit.
Yeah. Random Ruser confirmed. Now, I wish the bubbles were here. It looks so much more disrespectful when the bubbles were there. Oh, he's going to kill with Dragon's Tooth, isn't he?
Oh, sure. He is. Is he?
Yeah. Oh, no. No. The Phoenix kill. Do I want to play against Rakanser?
Yeah.
Random user. 1-1. Brings it back.
Who won the finals last time? I don't think I was there.
What were the finals? It was Scrapper versus
Random. Random won the last finals.
Yes, he did.
He's a returning champion. Here.
Returning champion.
But Rame is also a previous champion.
Yeah. You had
this
to consider
is actually the rematch in the last two.
Is it though? I don't think Random's actually played Rim.
No, it wasn't the final, but this is like the champion of champions we're making here.
Who will throw better? It's not over for Rednexler. Rednexler defeated Random User once. He might be able to do it again, but the same can be said for Random User.
And what the dream is that you build up a Hall of Fame over time, all the Mystic Builds Finals winners, and when you have at least 16, you have a final finals to determine the true champion of Mystic Builds.
Wow. But the same people win.
Yeah, you have to do more than 16 tournaments.
How do we make it unfair so that these fucking ridiculously good people don't always win?
Well, they won't, because in the finals, everyone's ridiculously good.
Yeah. Why do the bubbles bug out on your screen? I honestly have no idea. I don't know why the bubbles don't appear. Is it a setting? Is there a setting that doesn't show bubbles? If there is, tell me and I'll fix it. Mandam Ruza. Real question is, does Random think he can beat? Oh, is that...
He has the opponent in his sights. Well, the bear wants to play. I think Bireballs is a bear. I didn't really realize it before, but yeah. Bireballs is a bear.
Well, the bear will be playing shortly.
Yeah.
Bear, attend me. Ready, sir. Who will attempt to throw? Will any of them attempt to throw? Will they try hard? All these questions are about to be answered. It's a much better start for Rednexler this time. The extreme burst didn't really happen, did it? However, you don't want to get too close to Random User, otherwise the pain train starts rolling, and once it never stops.
Oh, the pain train has no brakes.
Oh, I think it was nearly. I think it was three hits there. Yeah. For the Phoenix really abusing the vertical memes there.
What an exploiter! He's many, many condi cleanses, completely cleanse himself.
And he has another one here with Manit Wave. That's another three conditions gone, and Rednexler is in pretty poor shape here. The comet lands, interrupts something.
That's gonna be it.
And that is it. And misform finish.
Oh, very classy from Random.
Yeah, it's pretty classy. So, Random User will move on to face Rim in the final. But first, before we do that, he's crying over having to face Rim. First, we must do our third place match, which will be Inny versus Red Naxxler. Oh, look. Rim, and then flipping over random user, as you can see in the... I'll switch back to the chat, so we need to see that. So you can see that a bear is flipping over random user. Bioballs is confident in the bear.
He is. Bioballs is a bear, so, you know.
Have a little recap of these builds that are going to be here for the third place.
Okay, come on, that's good to know.
It's going to be Reaper versus Scrapper. Now, here I would say the Reaper is probably a little bit better off, but is the build good enough? And I mean, he, actually, Red Naxxler even has Nothing Can Save You, so he can penetrate the blocks of Inny as well.
So that's going to...
Which could be good.
Quite nice. He's got a lot of Condi transfer, of course, as you do.
Yeah, but that doesn't matter against
That doesn't matter,
Scrapper,
against... Really. You'll just give him back some short-lasting vulnerability, most likely.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, actually, on the finals, I want to see nearly everyone betting. Just bet like 100 if you don't have very many.
Yeah, just go crazy.
I just want to see a really big bet, because, like, I don't know who's going to win it, to be honest. Could be anyone.
The problem here for Inny could also occur that he does have some cleanse. The elixir will cleanse because of alchemy. Alchemy is also a cleanse because it has the thingy. It converts a thing into a boon every some seconds or something. Healing turret cleanses. There's a decent amount here. And elixir gun, of course. This is certainly not ridiculously favored towards Red Naxxler. I mean, again, a lot of the thing with Reapers is if you can dodge the shout, if you can dodge the Shroud 5, if you can avoid getting hit by the Shroud 4, you're probably okay. You know, it's... It's not... It's all about dodging some of the ridiculously strong attacks, you know. It's going to come down to skill here, I think. I have to say, in this particular matchup, I'd say it favors the Reaper by default. But Scrapper is lethal in 1v1. Who are we to say that Inny cannot win? Will we see crazy meta? Yes, we will! Rune of the Svanir! Rune of the Svanir.
It's back.
That's actually wrong. It should be Rune of Svanir.
Oh, yeah. Because, yeah, they're the sons of Svanir, aren't they?
Yeah. So, about ready to go here. What will Red Naxxler be going with? Classic Mercenary Grenth. An excellent choice. The Legendary Wings here. No back piece. A sensible choice for Inny. Exclamation mark, bet red 100. Yeah.
Oh, the wings are very cool, actually, when they actually move around a little bit. They're cooler than they were before, at the very least.
Yeah.
The resident bingo bot.
Bingo bot.
In-game meta move.
We know a lot about the lore here on this stream. We are role players. This is an RP stream.
Lamb finisher doesn't even work anymore because you can't see finishes for some reason.
Yeah, if anyone actually knows a solution to that... let me know. It just started doing it, and all the finishers were assault finisher or something. I mean, I don't know how to stop that. If someone knows.
Cheers, Vicky, being late for quit match.
Yeah.
That's quite good.
Always late for Quiplash. Yep. Classic. Look at this. The high IQ strats getting some of that life force. Maybe that could have helped Plenix, actually.
Possibly. Oh, that's that's a...
There's the slick shoes, and there's the combo stun with the supply crate. Inny doing a great job right now. Not too many condies either. And, I think Red Naxxler was blinded, or did he cancel? No, he was blinded, I think, and therefore the shout didn't do anything. The rocket charge in, there's a lot of damage coming out, however. As the, you know, kind of the longer this goes on, the Reaper just starts, you know, as the cooldowns for the NG are expended, the Reaper just slowly whittles down his opponent, but corrupting boons constantly with that Scepter Auto attack there.
Reaper's too.
Oh, nice.
Full on, pretty much.
Just, yeah, but that doesn't really do a great deal, and it does get shut down pretty hard as the Reaper Shroud 5 is actually cancelled by running out of juice. Slight miscalculation.
Hmm.
That's, well, it was greedy. It was greed. But greed is good, so that's all right. There's a massive amount of conditions. Oh, no. Oh, the Soul Spiral actually gets cancelled. If that had gone off, that would have been GG. It's just too powerful.
Would have, and I think in this situation...
I think Innie... Oh, wow, Innie manages to survive.
Does, but for how long is he going to survive?
He does get have the a few now. Cleanses with all these elixirs.
Going back for the healing turret, is he? Oh,
but,
no,
oh rocket charge nearly gets some serious work done. But and the boon corruption...
Oh, it doesn't quite get it.
The corruption... Unfortunately.
So, somebody asked how the rules are for the tournament. You should probably go over them again.
Okay. The rules are for the tournament. These players all have semi-random builds. They're draft mode builds. Normally, this is the final, but normal builds are totally random. But these are only semi-random. So you pick them in a draft format, similar to Hearthstone Arena, if you're familiar with that. So these are kind of meta builds. They have some aspects of meta builds, but they'll be missing a trait here and there, and they have to kind of think about what they want when they create the build.
Yeah, because you might be like offered something like reactive armor, but then you also offer two insanely good other traits.
Exactly,
like...
yeah.
Actually, something I never really asked for. Can they get the same trait twice? Like, offered the same trade.
So yeah, you can gamble. Yeah, you can get offered it.
There you go.
Twice.
So you could turn down the first reactive armor and really hope you get it again in a minute.
You got all the wrong traits. Yes, that is true. The NG traits are kind of lacking here. In fact, they're lacking massively, but still. That Scrapper and Reaper are so bad, Lamau!
Well, oh, he's chatting shit.
Yeah. Chatting shit? Well.
Although, they might seem like they're bad because their builds are complete. Well, they're not complete trash. Their builds aren't exactly meta builds, though, so they're not going to be playing in the exact same way you normally would.
Oh my god. What the fuck is this? What is this abomination?
Scrabble play. You could say he played bad. He might come in and say.
This backpack.
What the hell is that backpack?
The hell is this?
How dense is Innie carrying an anvil on his back? don't diss him, Cyan. Let him say what
he wants. Cyan, the chat warrior.
If Innie wants to protect himself, then he will do that, I'm sure.
These players are all meme lords. They're in Mystic Builds finals. They deserve accolades.
Oh my god, the salt in chat just rode massively.
Yeah, the salt.
Everyone carry on, it's kind of funny.
Yeah, actually. This is hilarious. Chat, start going crazy. And does the shout land? No, it doesn't. It is blocked by Innie. Uses Plague Signet to break out of that stun. The Warhorn dazes doesn't really do a great deal, though.
I don't protect on our new dish out. Good point. Keep dishing out. Go for it. I had a change of heart. I quite like this.
Oh no, just transferred just as some conditions got applied. A little bit unfortunate there. It looks like Innie is doing some serious work. Did he? So what has changed here? Innie is just going to win.
Yeah, and he's just...
It's pretty quickly, actually. Yeah. I mean, it's... Yeah, it's over. Yeah. Oh, wow. Consume conditions is about half a second away. But... Oh, is this Elixir gun to death?
Oh, wow.
Looks like it is. Tranquilized! Oh, sick BM from Innie. So good. What is this? Turret. The turret MVP.
Out, this guy's gonna search his ancient vault of cancer memes.
Oh shit.
Oh, ancient
so that's
cancer memes,
be
wow.
1-1 there. Or, 1-1, I tell you. 1-1. But Innie. Making the comeback with the backpack. Now it's gone, though. Surely that is the source of Innie's great power. Without it, cannot win versus the onslaught of Red Naxxler.
He's the backpack.
Let's see if Renaxel will change up here. Or maybe. Just going to try and replicate that first game. So. Is this a prank? Oh no, random user, he failed Kipo. Again.
Oh, another Sudoku.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Bonk Jamp in brackets, not like this. Wow.
Wow. Order off the Rainbow Nazi.
Rainbow Nazi. Game starting up. The same strat. Oh, I think he switched from. Yeah, he switched from Grent to Crate here. So bleed duration very high, 65%. Same condition damage, and a little bit of a different use on the shout here. It will apply a stack of bleeding, torment, and poison whenever it's used. The cooldown's fairly long, so it's going to be just a little bit extra.
Yeah, it's going to make that. But if he does hit it, it's going to make that really.
It's a pretty big deal. The duration's long, yeah. 8 seconds, and that will be increased by the duration here as well.
Yeah, exactly.
So
another little cheeky side gate kill here. Let's see what happens. And Indy's having none of it. Here he is.
No,
everyone's
clean. Yeah. Did manage to get a little bit though, out of that. Oh, that! What a great play there. Goes for nothing can save you to make sure that the shout isn't blocked, so it could only be dodged. That was really nice there. But is this gonna be enough?
Chat is sending cancer.
Wow. Innie really is John Cena. The aggression is just infinite here. It's continuously trying to take down Red Naxler. Red Naxler is unblockable for a while, but doesn't seem to quite have enough damage to deal with the sustain of Innie. Yeah, Innie went for Melandry. It is the Melandry runes. It's carrying him, apparently.
Yeah, it's actually working out really well.
The thunderclap.
Red Axons can't hurt him.
Yeah, it's just not enough. I mean, with the duration reduction and adapted armor, that's 45% duration reduction on Condies.
That is nasty.
Unfortunately, for Red Axel, it started so well, but I think it's over, unfortunately.
Yeah.
It is, and the function gyro will secure the kill here. With a guild finisher, Quaggan with a knapsack. Wow.
God. This Sudoku command is actually so good.
It is. It's good, isn't it? Toot.
It's genius. It's actually kind of useful, because if no one bothers to check back using Better Twitch TV or something, you actually can't see the previous messages, so your dishonor is forever erased.
Oh, yeah. Well, this is the match that everyone has been waiting for. It is the clash of two meme titans.
Oh, God. The very frequently seen faces throughout Mr. Builds here. Random user.
Cyan says Innie isn't outie. That's actually pretty good.
Is it though?
Yes, it is. That's good. It's Rim versus random user. This is gonna get crazy. Either Rim will just completely destroy random user, or it's gonna go to Resident Sleeper. So maybe it's not gonna be that good. I mean, this druid build is disgusting.
Yeah, everyone bet on this one. Everyone do some betting. Come on. Get the builds out. Everum. I want
the druid. It's the druid.
The druid versus the focusers. I want everyone in chat to bet here. If you have, even if you have one clover, just bet it on a side because this is going to be sick.
Who is going to win? This could be interesting here, honestly. I mean, druid. The range doesn't really mean that much, seeing as random user is entirely ranged. However, having druid is ridiculously good. Having all this regeneration is insanely good. And Random has got no way to deal with that. He can't strip or corrupt boons because he's not... Well, he's an elementalist. That's not how they roll. Oh, wow. Random user's betting 1,000 clovers on himself.
Oh, that is brave. I like how he's allowed to do that. That is perfectly fine.
That is ballsy. Yeah. Very, very ballsy. There's a lot of clovers going into bets here.
Yeah, do it. So, yeah, if you're new to the chat, !clovers, see how many clovers you got.
Yeah.
And !bet, and then a color, and then a number, will bet the number of clovers on that color.
Oh.
So, like, !bet, blue, 1,000, will bet 1,000 clovers on blue. Just everyone do it. Let's get some clovers going in there.
There's a lot of Signet of Stone for Rim, going invulnerable. That's going to be very good against Fresh Air, obviously. Right, all in on blue. That is ballsy. I like it.
So I think even Celestial Avatar is going to help against Fresh Air because all he has to do is just land a CA3 and then that Fresh Air is now 2 seconds shorter.
Yeah.
Because of the days. He can get Ancient Seeds in there as well.
It is a big deal. This does not look good for Random User, I have to say. He thinks he can win, though. Maybe he can, but the thing is, I mean, you have Basically, you have this tiny window to kill Rim, okay? So when Troll Engine is on cooldown, and Celestial Avatar is on cooldown. Otherwise, yeah, he's just going to heal to full. And then it begins all over again, you know? I think it will be difficult for Rim to kill random, though. Because he has a lot of poison pressure from the sword, the dagger, rather. But he can't really keep it there because of the cleanse that random has.
And this is the issue with Rim's build. It just doesn't do anything, really. Yeah. It doesn't die. He's got a very, very... You can tell he was going for something tanky there because he's got the guard, he's got the stability, he's got the toughness there, he's got the Signet of the Wild, whatever it's called.
It's going to be very difficult for either of them to kill each other, I think. We'll have to see, though.
I have a feeling this is going to end with lots of YOLO runes. YOLO amulets, to be honest. Because it's currently Paladin versus Marauder, which is actually a pretty standard matchup. It's Paladin Scrapper, so Rim really doesn't want to die here. With Blood Air, Leeching, Hydromancy, charging out the Celestial Avatar. It's going to be kind of disgusting, really.
Yeah, it's just so fast. It's so fast. So, Random's going to have to kill Rim really fast, otherwise he'll never kill him.
Yeah.
You really overestimate Rim?
Oh.
I don't know.
Well, I've got an anti-fan for Rim here.
An anti-fan for Rim.
Here comes Rim the bear. The bear is coming.
Yeah, here it goes.
Oh!
And Rim is a very dangerous adversary. You have to bear that in mind. These are both excellent players. Can he do anything, though? I mean, not really. Thing is, unless you interrupt Aether Renewal, I mean, Rim is capable of that. Well, actually, apparently, he's just going to kind of kill Random User.
Well, not really, though. Random User's not going down just yet.
Yeah, he's certainly not dead. The Starve auto attack's so annoying. The noise it makes as well is so stupid. It's kind of, yeah, it's a really annoying sound when you know there's a druid chasing you. Yeah. Oh, Dragon's Tooth!
Oh, just dodged.
It nearly hits.
Almost hits, but it never hits, really.
Oh. Oh, look, that is a fresh air combo. It did about 10%.
That's a combo. Unloading damp memes.exe, there it is.
Hmm. This is going to be... Yeah, this is...
Yeah, this is going
to
be...
In fact, is Random User even trying to attack, or is he just going to run around in circles? Because he knows it will never end. Because honestly, it's not going to end. Wow, did you see how many Phoenix hits he got there? On the Drake?
Yeah, that was... Unfortunately, it's on the Drake, so no one really cares, but... You know.
This is Resident Sleeper.
Yeah, this is almost certainly going to go Resident Sleeper, isn't it? Because Rim isn't going to die.
Random won't die. No, none of them have enough damage to kill the other. Which is a pretty impressive for fresh air. You know, I mean, it's just... I mean, think Random has... He's not even using his cooldowns at this point. He still has Arcane Shield, a bonus Arcane Shield from his trait, and Misform. So, yeah, he can't do anything.
No, he...
They're just going to run around for 2 minutes?
They are.
No. Get your ass back here, slave. Bear, I summon you. Get your ass back here, slave. Red team got a capture point.
Yeah. There we go, another capture point win begins. It may as well be because this isn't going to end. Random's going in for it again. I guess he's, at this point it's just practice more than anything. Even that star throw, very annoying just getting Rim out of there.
I'm just going to put some Zeds in.
Rim's going for the Lord as you do, you know. The front gate.
You might even have enough time to get it, actually.
Return my money.
Alright, here he goes. Can he do it in a minute? Let's find out. Imagine if he goes for the Lord and dies as a result of that. That would be pretty funny.
Yeah, that would. Not gonna happen.
Hey,
though.
Finalists, have a good day. The battle never ends. Well, it definitely doesn't now. Definitely. This one's gonna continue until the timer runs out. Look at this damage. Wow. But also, look at the healing. I'm amazed Rim even bothered to go for a defensive amulet. Because he knows that it would just go to Zzz anyway.
Yeah, and he's going to get a little bit worse out.
The dragon's tooth!
It never hits.
Yeah. But with Marauder, instead of Paladin, maybe there's a chance that they might actually kill each other?
Maybe.
Two seconds.
The soldier is in. And nothing happens. Hey, finalists, have a good day. The chat, the chat's full of bears. This is always what happens against
four. There's bears everywhere.
Yeah.
Oh, a YouTube video.
What is it?
Never-ending... it's this, yeah. The never-ending battle story.
That's quite good.
It is pretty good. Appropriate reference is appropriate. One defensive meme. Let's see if this works. Nothing changes for random, so this, well, directly favors him. But again, they're actually not that much faster than one another. In fact, I guess Rim is quicker, right? He definitely is.
Why does Jordan even get triggered by bears? Me and Teapot spend a lot of time setting up chat and putting like nice tables down and stuff.
Yeah,
bears always come in and start throwing them around.
Yeah, it just gets crazy.
They have no respect. They've been okay today, but normally. It's a fucking disaster. There's bears everywhere.
Muse just threw it.
Oh, Muse just threw it, you reckon?
Really? Why did he... Oh, yeah, because he's doing it for the roleplay, isn't he?
Oh, yeah. Well, isn't it 1-1 now as well?
It's 1-1, yes. There we go, that's correct.
Bears have rights too, yeah. Their rights don't include throwing our tables around. Throw random user around though.
How does it feel to not have a rig build for once?
Oh.
They're wasting valuable time here. 30
yeah.
seconds.
This also might not end.
You do have to consider that, you know, if one of them is downed at the 0 minute, you know, the 0 second mark, they'll think back and think, oh no! If only,
yeah.
If only I had got in quicker, you know? Hey, will that Marauder amulet be too much for Rim to handle? I have no idea. Will the Dragon's Tooth? Will one... Oh, no!
Oh,
Dragon's Tooth is never lucky. The Signet never of Stone shuts it down.
What the fuck, not even crit? I think he's just typing as he goes along. It's like he's roleplaying as Modramoth.
Yeah, Modramoth roleplay. Hey, the rocks have been summoned for some toughness.
Dwayne the Rock Johnson.
What is he even doing at this? Is he just trolling me at this point? Is this what this is?
I don't even know. This isn't going to be another Resident Sleeper, is it?
Why is he running?
Come on, please.
This is a good chance for him to actually... Oh, does he... Oh, no, he's trying to... He's going to try and force it to YOLO. This guy's such a fucking tryhard.
Oh,
my God. Oh,
wow. That is an unconventional strategy. Is this allowed?
No. I'll just say they have to fight in the middle.
Yeah.
Maybe he's listening to the stream.
Yeah,
because this is the problem here is clear. It's the running, not the DPS. Well, actually, we don't know if the DPS is a problem.
Yeah, it's too much running to find out. Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. You better do your V phase. I see your plan, Random.
Muse, I would run the half.
Yeah.
I was like, April, you should join me.
Yeah. Oh. Oh!
doing? What is this?
What is this?
The problem is that Arena can't balance healing skills. Shots fired.
Oh my god. This stream is a bowler.
What?
Now I can't see this one ending.
Well, no, because they're not even attacking.
No, like not even the next one. I don't know. I don't. Can these guys even kill each other? That's the question. Without us making it really obviously rigged, you know.
This is rigged. This is rigged. But you're playing Conquest, not 1v1. What is it? What is even going on right now? There's a minute to go. Red team wins a capture point. Oh, there you go. He capped the point. What is he doing?
Oh, isn't that...
What the Wow. Oh, he's going for another point. Random users going for the Lord! What has happened to these finals? Seriously!
Oh my god, this used to be a PvP stream.
Yeah. This is just a clown fiesta.
Yeah, this is a circus stream now.
Okay. Killed it.
Oh my god. Right, can you get the Lord? That's the question. He's got 30 seconds, he might just die by accident.
He has the other misform though, so he's pretty safe, honestly.
Oh yeah.
Can he kill it in time? Probably not. Rim will just come and heal it.
Oh god, yeah.
Oh! Oh! He needs to be a little bit careful. Oh wait, no he doesn't. Yeah, 9 seconds.
Left. He's fine.
Yeah.
That one didn't end either. This final's a joke. It kind of is, I'm not gonna lie. Finally some content for a PvP level like me. Yeah, the raid stream's back, boys.
Yep. PvE. Gonna have to get rid of...
Get him!
Get him!
Oh my god.
Okay. Okay, I think Random can still survive though. So I think this will go to a YOLO deathmatch.
I hope it will, actually. That'll be. I don't know who's gonna favor at this point. I'm just kind of in it for the ride. See how it goes, you know?
In it for the memes.
In it for the memes.
They want the gems and they want it hard. Here we go.
Hold on to your points. All right.
Who will win? Scrapper, Marauder, Rimp. It's going to be Marauder and Eagle. Wait, is Random User just going to run around in circles? Until he
maybe.
It's ridiculous. I should change classes and not play Bunker Healer shit builds like Druid. Oh wait, hang on, wait. Is Random User just trolling again? Because why? He's doing lots of damage now.
Oh, if this is 2-2 now, isn't it? So if that was actually his plan, that would be... Very clever.
Imagine if this was his plan to lure Rim to the middle. Oh my god. If this is just another mind game by Random, this is ridiculous.
Can Random kill him?
Not really. It's okay because Rim can't kill him either.
Oh wait, or can he?
Oh, apparently he can.
Yeah, this could be Ogre, but 5 seconds to Random as heal.
Well, he's got... Heal, wow, that's a lot of damage. Signet of Stone, though.
And that's gonna be it?
Yeah.
Is it over? That was it? Well.
Oh, the bear is going to maul him to death. Flip the table. Nice BM.
It's over. What the hell?
Is it, though? Does that second one really count? Are we really going to go to 2-2?
I think we gotta have one. Can we expect any other results?
This piece of shit can't play without a build that can die. Resident Sleeper.
It is Resident Sleeper, yeah.
I think you have to send yourself all these packets of salt that he had prepared. It's okay, he already has them.
Alright, let's make chat vote on it.
You think chat should vote?
Yeah, I'll make a poll.
I don't know, there's just two draws in a row, it's just, ugh.
Yeah.
You know, it's, ugh. It's just boring, you know? It doesn't count even though I have a hatred for Musa. Honestly, to be honest, if Ganloss...
Yeah, Ganloss
is
deciding this time.
If Ganloss is saying it doesn't count, then...
Alright, so it's 2-1.
Let's be real, yeah, it's 2-1.
Randall's got a chance to get back in there.
Yeah, if Ganloss says it doesn't count, then it doesn't count. Because he has a deep, deep hatred for random user.
Deep. Those Jockstrap Cowboys.
Full YOLO? Fired
up.
Seeing those stone gone, you dead? Druid, oh, I see. Druid gone, you dead. Random, trash talking. Is it going to work, though?
Early guard there, that's quite interesting.
He wants the regen.
Yeah.
Maybe he wants the swiftness to get him into position quicker, actually.
Ah, that's quite clever, yeah.
Because the regen doesn't do anything from right now, because he's not in combat.
Fire Great Sword, he's out already.
What's he going to do with that, though? He's going in. Going for a Spinnerino. So fast, the super speed on air achievement. Oh, he had weakness for that opening combo, though.
Oh,
already, things not looking good for random user. But he is getting some good damage here. Can he keep it going?
I don't know, because Rune is good at not dying. He's got a very tanky build in there.
He does.
He's still got Signet of Stone as well.
Well, I mean, honestly, the only way random can really do this is just by surviving. And trying to go for Resident Sleeper at this point.
Yep.
And trying to prove that he can't be killed unless Rim also goes YOLO. Because right now he's just dying. And not even slowly, he's dying fast.
He is, he's just running out of HP and the Rim just trolling and is just such a massive heal. Rim's not gonna die.
Yeah, he's not gonna die here.
No.
He misforms, goes to Earth, probably for trying to go for Obsidian Flesh. But Rim, you know, he's going for the kill.
He's going in, he won't die. And...
there's the Obsidian Flesh. The next heal is available for random. He's going to super speed away. Might be able to survive.
He's back on decent health again.
Yeah, he's back up. Rim, maybe you're getting a little bit worried then. Because if this goes to Resident Sleeper, it will be full YOLO middle fight.
Oh.
Although, honestly, I'm not even sure if that would be enough, honestly. That would be as good as it could be for random, but...
Celestial Avatar is just too much.
Yeah, it is too much. And he has Signet of Stone and just ways to deal with the DPS, you know?
Yeah.
So, a lot of factors here are just too much for random, I think. What's Rim thinking? Let's get into it. Let's roleplay as Rim. Let's chase, let's follow him.
Alright, there you go. Follow Rim. Pretend we're Rim. Oh.
Celestial. Yeah, well, obviously the key here is going to be having poison on him. But the thing is, it's not the key, though. Because poison gets cleansed on the first tick of Aether Renewal. He will try and kill. Getting some pretty good damage off here. But will that be enough?
I don't know, it doesn't seem like it will be. Random is not getting any damage out. The second he does anything,
just well, the thing is, he's playing defensive. Wait, the thing is, he's actually kind of not, though.
Yeah.
I think he was just playing a bit better than he was last time, honestly. He's not dying this time.
He's not.
But the sword is out this time. The staff is away. The sword is in business.
Trojan regenerating the health.
Yeah. Oh wait. Okay, maybe he's dead actually.
Oh no, staff didn't do that much damage, so he's gonna get away for now.
Oh, he's gonna get the heal. The LOS Fiesta. Oh, views of obsidian flesh coming a bit early though. This is curious. Yeah. Is this finals or past scrap footage? Because it was Resident Sleeper. Nice meme. We're role-playing as Athene today. This is all pre-recorded, by the way. This is all pre-recorded.
Yep. All of this is pre-recorded, yep. Including chat.
Yeah. Why do you think we're not on camera? Chat, so yeah. We can't put shoe on head to prove it.
Exactly. Everyone in chat is actually paid to say stuff.
Yep. They're all paid actors.
Yep.
Just like everyone in 9/11.
But I don't know why we're telling you that, because you're also a paid actor.
Yeah, doesn't make any difference. Druid versus Tempest, no scrapper here. That is an excellent fact. There are none of these players are scrappers.
Yeah.
Good observational skills there. Yeah.
Well, Dragonsteed may have even hit there, but it doesn't make a difference. The rune's going to heal up again. Run away from the bear. This is going to get a Resident Sleeper, isn't it? No way.
Yeah, it's
oh my god.
It's Ellie, not Tempest. That is true. I'm just so accustomed to never seeing a normal Ellie.
See, all your gear are pre-recorded now. There you go.
Never. My gear is mine.
Oh, no.
Okay. Oh, okay, never mind.
Nope.
YOLO or NOLO?
Worst finals EU, pretty much.
Okay. The thing is, if he goes YOLO, random still has no health, you know? I mean,
yeah.
This is the thing. I'm not sure if it's going to help, really. I mean, having him as Zerka is good, but.
Yeah.
All he's lost is vitality. You know, I mean, I guess this means that random's going to do a lot more damage because of extra ferocity.
I don't know. I just feel like he's not going to be able to kill Rim. That's the issue because Rim is invincible.
Right. Okay, so he's going Eagle Berserk here. Look at this ferocity, though. 216%. And with Fresh Air, he gets another 16%. So he's going to be at 233% ferocity. So going with leeching. Good thing about leeching is that it's armor ignoring.
Yeah. So Trollingen is going to heal for half Rim's health and
look at this bear. They're so derpy. As
well. Yeah, I love the bear. Bear is best pet.
Yeah, it is. Bear is new meta.
It's nearly as good as pig.
Resident Sleeper. Rim. Ranger without the wolf mask. Interesting. Mm. Druid, rather.
A cool hat, though. Look how cool that hat is.
If you are the ultimate Clover Lord, you also get a 10% bonus on every single clover earned by any user. Thank you for your attention. Wow.
That'll be pretty crazy. But it was mean the rich get rich. It'd be like Donald Trump. Small owner of a million clovers.
All right. Here we go! Full YOLO. Zerka versus Zerka.
Oh, this is gonna be a clown fiesta.
Anosaur! I didn't notice that, was it always called that? That's Anosaur. Good. Okay, fiery greatswords in. He gets the gale, but that gets shut down by the stability. Can random bring Rim down? No, I don't think he. Look at the starve damage, it's so annoying.
So, yeah.
Oh?
Rim's heal though.
There's a troll engine, he just needs a bit more burst. Yeah, celestial beams. This can't possibly go to Resident Sleeper.
I think it.
Oh, wait, is he bored?
I think he's just. Is he bored?
Oh, no, he's not bored.
He's just kind of BMing.
I don't even know what he's doing at this point. Two skills.
Just two skills.
He's not happy with Druid. That's okay, not many people are.
No.
So much sustain, though.
Random user is playing piano while Rim is rice cooking pizza like Rampart. Oh my god.
Oh, we could get a nice gale here. Oh, he doesn't go for it though. He goes straight to fire. And then, oh, and he actually, no, he did use it. It just missed or something. Never mind.
We've actually lost 60 viewers from this.
No!
Oh my god.
Come back! What a
this
disaster.
This is such a clown fiesta.
Clown fiesta.
Ban goddamn Druid in the finals. Holy shit, it would remove Ranger, but that's just the best.
Oh my god. Right, this is this gonna be Resident Sleeper?
No,
oh, no! It looks like Random's gonna die.
Yeah.
He's dead.
What can he do?
Yeah, he's dead. He's done for. It's only a matter of time! He can try and blind! Oh, he's down!
Yeah, he went
he's
down.
He's missed! But Rim...
It's gonna be it.
...is gonna take it. Hashtag Anet knows balance. Oh, and he baby rages!
He's done here.
He's done with this shit. And Rim is gonna take it 3-1. Did you see that? Red team got a capture point. Wow.
The bad.
Just wow. Rim is the Mystic Bills champion for his third time.
Wow.
Oh, the Bears are here.
The Bears are
very Digital happy. Sports. Well said, useless data.
Oh, the Bears are throwing tables.
Copious amounts of Bears.
Yeah, so many Bears in chat.
Skillful Druid place feels good, man. Would you look at that? Rim is the victor.
Wow.
Yeah. He has won 3-1 over Random User, who will come in second. But don't worry about Random User, you know, he's alright. He still gets 400 gems for having the most points on the leaderboard. He also gets some gold for doing this, but his build, when it mattered, not quite rigged enough. And in third place is Innie, an excellent scrapper player. But again, losing to Rim, is that really that bad?
No, yeah. I don't feel like there's a whole lot he could have done, to be honest.
Yeah.
That Drew was just unstoppable. It was amazing.
It was completely unstoppable. And Red Naxler in fourth. Well deserved. I mean, nearly managed to defeat Random User. No, 2-1.
Yeah.
It's close. Close indeed. Go to your Reddit cave, Random. Says Rim. But, yeah. That is it, guys.